And that's the
guys who can play.
Who can run, and they get guys who can play some defense.
Absolutely. The Giants on defense, they can get after you. They can just wreak havoc on the passer. And in today's rules of football, you can wreak havoc on the passer. You can neutralize some of these explosive passes.
Even just with four guys. Now, Atlanta, man, they talk about a recurring theme for them this year. It's one of the reasons they didn't win the division. Although the Saints are unreal at the moment. Mm-hmm. And one of the reasons that they couldn't stay in this game, Trent.
It's a history. Today was a reflection of their history. And this is a box score. This tells you all the yards a team gets rushing. My philosophy on box scores in the running game is they don't mean squat. You are what you are as a running team in must-run situations. And the Falcons can run the ball on first and second down all you want, look really good doing it. This is their history. Today was a reflection of their history. Fourth and inches. Can't get an inch. Can't get an inch. Because this is who they are. Again, can't convert a fourth and short. Now, this is not a just today thing for the Atlanta Falcons. This happened, signature moment this season against the New Orleans Saints. They couldn't convert on a fourth down overtime. Gave the New Orleans Saints the ball. And you look at teams and what their personality is, and any great competitor, any great leader from all time will tell you, you are what you are in the most difficult moments in life. That's in football, the most difficult moment is that half a yard when they know you're running, you know they're running, I know they're running, everybody knows they're running, go get it. This is who the Falcons are.
There's some teams built to win 16 games, not to win 16 games, but to get in the playoffs in a 16-game season. And at the moment, the Atlanta Falcons are a nice team that's made it three of the last 4 years. But unfortunately, they have no right moving on. They should be ashamed of themselves. I mean, you give the Giants complete credit today. Because a front four in this day and age, that's like the fierce supports.
That's great.
But you gotta be able to man up here against the best teams in football. And to the moment, the Falcons haven't yet figured that out. The Giants sure have. They've manned up against all the Ryans. The Rex Ryan, the Rob Ryan, the Matt Ryan. Maybe Nolan Ryan will be next week. I don't know. That'll be the Packers. When we return, more on NFL Primetime. You might have heard Tim Tebow threw a bomb in overtime to beat the Steelers. If you didn't hear, we'll be back.
NFL Primetime is presented by E-Trade. Investing unleashed.
Want to know the difference between a trader and an elite trader? It's this.
The E-Trade Pro platform. Fast, beautiful, totally customizable. Finds top performing stocks in three clicks. Quickly scans the market for new trading ideas. It can even match option strategies to your goals and lets you see the potential risk and reward. And it also comes with a dedicated elite service team. Got it? Get it? Good. Introducing new E-Trade Pro Elite.
What's up, guys?
Hey, man, it's not a Miller Lite. What's the big deal?
Miller Lite has more taste.
Strike two. One more, you lose your man card.
Wait, what was strike one?
Hey, I'm running low on beef. Hey.
Wait, but how did you guys get your beef?
We bought them.
Man up and choose Miller Lite. We add hops not once, not twice, but three times. Brewed for that great Pilsner taste.
Whoa. She must have paid a fortune.
We tried to be like every band we possibly could until we became Maroon 5.
It took us a long time. I mean, we're still working on it, trying to get the best sound that can possibly go out to our audiences. You know, that feeling where you just don't know how it happened, but it sounds incredible to you and the audience. It comes out super clean.
It's never better than that. It doesn't ever get better than that.
Who's Hungry is brought to you by Snickers, who remind you to play hungry, but not literally hungry. And watch the film The Man Who Played Literally Hungry at NFL.com/Snickers.
And now our Snickers Who's Hungry. Tom, not going anywhere for a while.
Well, Timmy Tebow, what a big day for him. The most important day of his career. He threw for over 300 yards. He gets the Broncos to advance in the playoffs. Averages 31.6 of pass completion. What a day for him.
It was. And how about a day for the Hakeem Nicks? Both touchdown catches. The first one was a sick grab. This was a sick run. And how about the third and eight shoestring catch? Hakeem Nicks, he was hungry.
Well, and look, you catch the longest play in overtime in the history of the NFL at postseason. Demaryius Thomas, 11 seconds, 80 yards, game over. We're going to New England on a Saturday night on the 10-year anniversary, really, of the Tuck game, because why wouldn't you play Saturday night against the champ of the AFC West? Yes. That's what happened 10 years ago when New England started their role and they played the Oakland Raiders. I don't know if it'll snow. It's about the time of the year that you'll have it. Denver comes from the snow. New England, we live in the snow. We're snowed under here. This was fun, huh?
It was good.
What a blast.
It was good. That was awesome.
Thanks for having me.
By the way, the playoffs are here. This just in. Thanks for watching Primetime.
Thanks, Chris, and welcome to Ladd People Stadium in Mobile, Alabama. It's the 2012 GoDaddy.com Bowl. Tonight, it's the 10-2 Red Wolves of Arkansas State taking on the 10-3 Huskies of Northern Illinois. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to the second-to-last college football game of the season. We're expecting a good one here tonight. Alongside my partner, Danny Cannell, I'm Clay Matvick. We could have some fireworks tonight. Arkansas State comes in on a 9-game winning streak. Only LSU has one more in a row than Arkansas State, and they average 34 points per game. Northern Illinois, they've won 8 straight. They average 38 points per game. And these quarterbacks are outstanding.
Yeah, both these offenses love to put up points. They both have spectacular quarterbacks, but they go about things just a little bit different. For Arkansas State, Ryan Applin leads the show at quarterback. He's more of a pocket passer, likes to spread it around, runs their high-tempo, fast-tempo offense almost to perfection. On the flip side, for Northern Illinois, you've got Chandler Harnish. If you're just tuning in from the NFL playoffs and you saw what Tim Tebow did, you're going to love the way Chandler Harnish plays the quarterback position. He is the definition of dual threat, so much so he could become the first player ever in college football history to rush for 1,500 yards and throw for 3,000 yards tonight.
We are going to be keeping close tabs on those two records here tonight. Northern Illinois won the toss, and they have deferred to the second half, so Arkansas State in the white uniforms with red pants will receive. There's Tyler Wedel. He'll kick it off. Rod Hall and Andrew Tryon are back deep for the Red Wolves, the champions of the Sun Belt Conference. They went 8-0 in league play this year. Beautiful night here in Mobile. 64 degrees, light winds. It is just beautiful on the Gulf Coast. And we are underway in the GoDaddy.com Bowl. From the 5. This is Andrew Tryon, the redshirt freshman. Good return. Out across midfield to the 46 of Northern Illinois, and the kicker made the tackle.
Wow, and a huge start for Arkansas State. It's going to start with huge, great field position. You see the nice blocking up front, a missed tackle right there in the front, but a good job by the kicker with a touchdown saving tackle. So much has been made about both these teams' offenses, but when you have some time off, sometimes the special teams can be just as important of a factor.
So here comes the Sun Belt Conference Player of the Year, Ryan Applin. 3,200 yards passing, over 600 rushing, both team highs. First play, play action. Throws, and it's a strike. Caught. First down catch for Taylor Stockamer, the junior receiver. He has almost 1,500 career receiving yards.
Taylor Stockamer just ran about a 15-yard comeback on the outside. Ryan Applin recognized the coverage and made a nice throw.
Jamal Bass on the tackle. There you see the numbers for Applin. Very accurate. Completes almost 66% of his passes. Trouble with this one. And down he goes. Applin is dumped by Kyle Jenkins, the defensive end.
Oh, and Applin just lost the handle on the football, trying to run a bubble screen. You want to get it out of your hands quick. Ball just slipped right out of Applin's hands right there. He's lucky he got it back.
So a loss of 5. This one is complete. Dwayne Frampton will get a good chunk back for the Red Wolves as Pat Schiller, the middle linebacker, makes the tackle. But Frampton, Danny, is Applin's favorite target.
Oh, he's been a stud for him all year. Works out of the slot. A lot of possession-type throws, like the one he just caught there. Really sets up the deep game nicely on the outside.
That's going to bring up 3rd down and 5 for Arkansas State. Opening series for the Red Wolves. Applin throws, complete again. It's Frampton, first down at the 20, as the Red Wolves are in the red zone for the first time tonight. It's a gain of 7.
Frampton, we talked about the quick routes he likes to run. That time there, just run a 5-yard out. Knows where the first down is, and a perfectly placed ball by Applin. Here they come, right at you.
Wasting no time, another quick snap. This time it's Stockermer, and he'll dive down inside the 15-yard line. Jordan Delagall makes the stop, and it's another pickup of 6.
Both these teams run these high-tempo offenses where you wonder how they're going to be affected by so much time off with their rhythm. But right now, Arkansas State clearly looks comfortable in this offense.
You just saw the interim head coach, David Gunn. Gus Malzahn ready to take this program over after the season. Tight end in motion. Second and 4. Handoff. Lawson, his first carry tonight. It's going to be a short game. Derek Lawson, the senior, playing in his final collegiate game, picks up 2.
Arkansas State looked like they were predominantly favoring the pass. That was the first run they ran all game, trying to slip one inside, almost just to keep Northern Illinois honest at this point in the game.
Third down and 2. This team 44% on the year on third down. First in the Sun Belt. Applin takes a long look to the sideline and checks. Inside handoff, it's Lawson again. He's going to be about a yard and a half short of the first down. A gain of 1 as Jason Meehan and Schiller combine on the tackle. Now a decision here for David Gunn. And it looks like he's going to send the field goal unit out.
Now, I think it's the right decision at this point in the game. It's early. Get some points on the board. Get your confidence going.
So Brian Davis comes on. He's had a busy year. See his numbers. There is a penalty flag.
There's a substitution issue.
Substitution to by the offense. 5-yard penalty. It remains fourth down.
Tom McCreesh, our lead official tonight from the ACC.
This will drive a coach nuts. You've had so much time to practice your substitutions with the extra practices. It's just unexplainable how you cannot have the guys on the field at the right time.
So Davis, the long of 47 this year. Set up here from 33. Out of the hold of Neely Sullivan. And Arkansas State, with that high potent offense, draws first blood. It's 3-0 here at the GoDaddy.com Bowl in Mobile.
That. How are we gonna deal with this? If we can get to that tree line, we can better defend ourselves.
Here they go!
Go! Go!
Those things in your life, whatever they might be, make you want that next minute more than the last. Make you fight for it.
Don't stop!
The Gray, rated R, starts January 27th.
Hello, we're delighted to welcome you to Mobile, a dynamic global city that holds a magical mixture of world-class entertainment, stellar museums, fine dining, and historic attractions. Join us for a journey through Mobile. We hope to see you soon in Mobile, Alabama.
Hey, Clark, what you got there?
It's my number. It's the amount I need to save to retire the way I want. Is that your number?
Yeah.
A gazillion, huh?
Bazillion. It's just a guesstimation.
Oh, how do you plan for that?
Well, I blindly throw money at it and hope something good happens.
So you really don't have a plan?
I really don't.
Do you know your number? We can help you find yours and take steps to get there. Learn more at ing.com/US.
Watch ESPN lets you watch the ESPN networks streaming live on your tablet,
smartphone, or computer. Download the Watch ESPN app or visit WatchESPN.com. Only available on Time Warner Cable, Verizon Fios, and Bright House Networks.
Hi, I'm Bob Parsons, CEO and founder of GoDaddy. We're excited to sponsor today's GoDaddy.com Bowl.
Look, Bob, I got special GoDaddy pom-poms.
At GoDaddy, getting online is easy and affordable.
GoDaddy!
I'm also proud to announce we're doing it again. Our GoDaddy.me scholarship program. We're going to give $10,000 to 10 lucky students to go to college.
Free ride on GoDaddy! Here, Bob, I got some for you, too.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Good start for David Gunn's Red Wolves. He said this moments ago to his team.
Bleach. Man, how many speeches have you heard? Say it again.
Two men.
So if you need another speech, keep your butt in here.
After a long season, plus a 36-day layoff, nobody needs to hear any more speeches.
I love it. Short and sweet. If you're not ready to play 5 minutes before game time, you don't belong there. I love that short and sweet speech.
And Dave Gunn will be retained by Gus Malzahn, has been hired to stay at a place he's been for 10 years.
Yeah, and he was thrilled about the decision. He's been there for 10 years. I think he's really going to help out with the transition just to smooth things over a little bit.
Bobby Zalad has it teed up for the Red Wolves. Tommy Lee Lewis and Tommy Davis back to return. Line drive kick. Tommy Lee Lewis has to scramble back for it. And he's going to try and run out of the end zone. That's going to be a touchback, but an ugly looking decision there by Lee Lewis.
I think he touched the ball when it was initially coming at him, so there was a little bit of confusion there. All right, so the official, I think if you're a lip reader, you could tell that he said no one did touch the ball on the way to the end zone. It was a low line drive, kind of a knuckleball kick. He actually did hit that with his right arm.
Tommy Lee Lewis, a freshman, earlier this season had two returns for touchdowns. Here, Northern Illinois starts at the 20. Chandler Harnish hands off on the first play. Jasmine Hopkins going right up the middle. No gain. Harnish owns or shares 24 team records. He needs 118 rushing yards and 58 passing to become the first player in FBS history to rush for 1,500 and pass for 3,000 in the same season.
Yeah, probably his best statistic, though, is he's 21-5 as a starter. Helped Northern Illinois to the MAC title.
MAC Player of the Year, second down and 10. Punks rolling out on the run. Complete. And that's a first down for Northern Illinois as Perez Ashford, the junior from Shaker Heights, Ohio, makes a nice play.
It's a big-time throw from Chandler Harnish. A lot of people talk about, can he play at the next level? This is the type of throw all the way deep down the field that Perez Ashford delivers a bullet. Very accurate passer when he does choose to go down the field.
And now a penalty against the Huskies, a holding call.
Illegal block in the back. Number 68 in the offense. 10 yards from the spotter. It remains second down.
Actually, a block in the back. It's on Keith Otis. A senior from Chicago. So second down at 15 now for the Huskies on their opening possession. Harnish will send a receiver in motion, Luke Ekus. Harnish looking like he's going to run the option, keeps, and his helmet comes off as he's dumped for a loss by DeMario Davis, the heart and soul of that Arkansas State defense.
Chandler Harnish is a very accomplished runner, and Arkansas State has had a month to prepare for every type of run look they're going to get from Chandler Harnish. And this is going to be Northern Illinois' biggest challenge since they faced Wisconsin early in the season. They only put up 7 points versus them. Now Chandler Harnish having some equipment issues. to actually having to come off the field.
And Jordan Lynch, the backup quarterback, comes on.
How about this situation for your backup to be running on the last second? How much time does he have to even think about this play? You'd hope it's a draw or something simple.
Throws it short. Underneath, it is complete. That is Hopkins. But Arkansas State doing a great job defensively, forcing a three-and-out situation for Northern Illinois.
That was a pretty simple play, just a screen pass, which is a good thing for Jordan Lynch coming cold off the bench. And Harnish is going to have to get that helmet looked at, taken care of, so he can take the field the next series.
So Ryan Neer comes on to punt from inside the Huskies' five-yard line. Dwayne Frampton back to return for Arkansas State as we're under 9 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. Fair catch called for at the 42 by Frampton. That's where Arkansas State will have it as we check in with Kara Capuano for the first time.
Guys, in separate conversations, both of the head coaches of these programs told us they have the same futuristic vision. They want to be the Boise State. Northern Illinois head coach Dave Dornan said they want to be the Boise State of the Midwest, and Gus Malzahn told us not long ago that the Red Wolves want to be the Boise State of the South. Obviously, 11 wins is on the line for one of these teams, and both teams have had successful seasons that lay a fine foundation for those head coaches.
Thanks, Kara. Yeah, a huge improvement for Arkansas State. Six more wins this year than last year when they finished 4-8. Ryan Applin going back to work, flea flicker. Deep downfield, has a man wide open. It's caught inside the 20. Taylor Stockamer down to the 8-yard line. A 50-yard play for the Red Wolves.
Well, they ran the flea flicker, and the secondary absolutely bit on the run action. That's what allowed Stockamer to get behind the defense for the easy completion and huge play for Arkansas State.
First down and goal. Applin, quick strike, tipped out of the hands of Jarbo. Couldn't hang on.
Check out the secondary players right here. Watch their reaction to the run, the handoff. See him right there bite up, and then Stockamer doesn't hesitate at all, runs straight down the field, and that's as wide open as you'll get. Actually, the backside corner was the one who made the play.
So after the first incompletion by Applin, second down and goal. End around. Boy, Northern Illinois was ready for that. Earl Lucas tackled by Jamal Bass behind the line of scrimmage.
They ran sort of a version of a Statue of Liberty. Watch the play fake out to the bubble screen, then just slips it underneath for the handoff. But Northern Illinois, great job backside contained there for Northern Illinois. Jamal Bass.
Yep, and Jay Neenan, the defensive coordinator, really likes him, says he gets better every week. Big play there for the Huskies. Third down and goal. Applin pumps under pressure, tipped and knocked down. Kyle Jenkins, who is starting for Sean Progar. Big play tonight. Progar, the starter. A DUI arrest the night after the MAC championship. Not here tonight. They need him to play well, and he comes up with a big play there.
He did a great job of reading the screen. Saw it coming from a mile away and batted it down perfectly.
So Davis comes on again, this time from 36 yards out. Hit from 33 on the opening series to make it 6-0. And he does. So Arkansas State scoring twice, but Northern Illinois holding him to field goals.
You promised, Clay, this wasn't going to be like the SEC game, but we've seen some big plays. Hopefully we'll see some touchdowns soon.
6-0 Arkansas State.
Hello, we're delighted to welcome you to Mobile, a dynamic global city that holds a magical mixture of world-class entertainment, stellar museums, fine dining, and historic attractions. Join us for a journey through Mobile. We hope to see you soon in Mobile, Alabama.
When it comes to home insurance, surprises can be a little scary.
And a little costly. That's why the best agents present their clients with a lot of options.
Because when it comes to what's covered and what's not, nobody likes surprises.
We totally thought you were...
Obscure space junk falling from the sky? We covered that. Moving on.
We are insurance.
We are farmers. Bum, ba-dum, bum, 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 bum.
If you have gout and think a few attacks a year are all you have to worry about, think again. Fact is, gout can attack silently even between flares. You may not feel it, but gout's root cause, high uric acid, can allow crystals to continuously form and build up in your joints. Over time, this may lead to attacks in other joints, constant pain, and joint destruction. So don't wait. Get more information at goutinfo.com and talk with your doctor about ways to keep your uric acid at a lower, healthy level.
Calories, 2.6 carbs, and one exceptionally smooth taste, Michelob Ultra is perfectly balanced for your liking.
ESPN College Football, the GoDaddy.com Bowl, is brought to you by GoDaddy.com, domains, websites, and everything in between. And Farmers Insurance. Visit Farmers.com to find an agent. We are insurance. We are Farmers.
Teams taking a tour of the USS Alabama here in Mobile this week. 6-0 Arkansas State on top of Northern Illinois. A pair of field goals for the Red Wolves. And the Huskies set to get it back. Latest game ever for both of these teams, Danny. 36 days since they last played. And Arkansas State especially grateful for the extra time considering the coaching upheaval that they've gone through.
Especially those assistant coaches who are new to their position. First time calling plays for Tyler Siski since he was back as a high school coordinator.
So far, everything working out for Arkansas State. From the 4-yard line, Tommy Lee Lewis tries to bounce it to the outside, and he's cut down at the 20. Now, tomorrow night, it's the rematch everybody's been waiting for. Tyrann Mathieu leads top-ranked LSU against Trent Richardson in the second-ranked Crimson Tide. The All-State BCS National Championship on ESPN, ESPN Radio, ESPN 3D, ESPN 3, and also streaming live on WatchESPN.com. If there was an ESPN 4, we'd have it there, too.
So pretty much you have no excuse to miss that game. I know being here in Mobile, Alabama, I was out today. Saw a lot of Alabama gear around. There's Chandler Harness on the sideline still. We saw him get nicked on that run he attempted. His helmet came off. Maybe it's something more serious than equipment.
So Jordan Lynch stays in, the backup quarterback. And so far, it has been tough for the sophomore out of Chicago. A loss of 4 yards on the play as Justin Robertson rolls in to make the hit.
And here comes Chandler Harness back on the field. Jordan Lynch, after that play, I'm sure he's more than happy to go to the sideline. This Arkansas State defense really looks like they're ready to get after it so far at this point in the game.
This is the best defense Northern Illinois has faced since Wisconsin. Pumping right is Harness, rolling left and throwing on the run. Off target intended for Perez Ashford. Here are the early numbers on Harnish and Northern Illinois. This is not what they are used to doing.
No, and the surprising thing is that Northern Illinois, they're still getting warmed up, though. I really feel like the time off, it's going to take them some time to figure out Arkansas State, to get comfortable, to find their rhythm and timing.
Well, that's what happened in the MAC title game. Fell behind 20 points to Ohio and rolled back to win. Third and 13. Harnish, draw play, steps up, finds a seam, takes a pop at about the 23-yard line. Don Jones, number 5, laying the wood. A gain of 6.
Well, that's the second time Chandler Harnish has gotten hit really, really hard. Right at the end of that play, Jones, number 5, he read it from a mile away, saw the quarterback draw, and just went on a straight beeline for Chandler Harnish.
This Arkansas State defense ranked in the top 20 in run defense, pass efficiency defense, and total defense. Frampton back to return. As Arkansas State's going to get it back again. Ryan Neer gets it away.
Frampton calls for the fair catch. Penalty flag down.
Dave Doran out there trying to get figured out.
Interference. Number 30, Northern Illinois. 15 yards on the spot of the foul. First
down. So far, Northern Illinois, a little sloppy early on.
Akeem Daniels, the culprit on that penalty. Back to Mobile in a moment.
I have an assignment.
She thought she was protecting our nation until she discovered the truth.
You sold me out.
Kill her.
Go!
Now.
You need to turn yourself in. Do it for the sake of your father.
The only way to survive is to find someone she can trust.
One friend's not a lot.
It depends on who it is.
She's here.
Isn't there someone you should be calling to bring help? Haywire. Rated R. January 20th.
Where are the Navy's new high-tech combat ships being built?
Mobile County, Alabama.
Where did this $5 billion state-of-the-art steel facility just open?
Mobile County, Alabama.
Where are engineers designing better jets, and where are U.S. Coast Guard aircraft serviced and repaired?
In Mobile County, Alabama.
Top economic publications tout Mobile County for economic growth, job growth, and the cost of doing business. It's Mobile County, Alabama.
Super Tuesday, Georgia, Florida at 7, Ohio State, Illinois at 9 on ESPN.
Emily's just starting out and on a budget, like a ramen noodle every night budget. She thought Allstate car insurance was out of her reach until she heard about the value plan. Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you like Allstate.
See war like never before. Get the Emmy Award-winning miniseries World War II in HD, along with two feature-length specials in the World War II in HD collector set, available with Vietnam in HD, at Barnes & Noble Music and DVD locations and at VN.com.
Hello?
Why always the deception stutter step before the truth?
Because it extends our quality father-daughter time.
Bang!
Sometimes you are the perfect man.
Thank you.
Probably the best clothes in the world.
You're hitting on a married woman.
I know.
It's the ABCs of me, baby.
Why are you hitting?
Because I bloody well stammer!
Untamed and Unlocked, the Showtime free trial. Tune in now, only on Showtime.
That's good.
Tune in to the Showtime free trial now.
Back outside the stadium here in Mobile, Alabama. There you see the bus, the DirecTV Mobile studio, making an appearance here at the 2012 GoDaddy.com Bowl. And don't have far to go tomorrow night. Just 2 hours from here is New Orleans for the national championship game.
That's the third drive in a row, Arkansas State has started with outstanding field position. I'm sure they're frustrated they've had to settle for two field goals.
And a marker. And this is going to back Arkansas State up.
Third snap, false start. Number 74 offense. Five.
That's Zach McKnight, the right tackle. And that'll put him at the 46-yard line.
Still isn't bad field position to start off with, though.
Third drive inside Northern Illinois territory, as you alluded to. Applin hands off to Frankie Jackson. His first run of the night. The freshman was provided some spark in the run game for Arkansas State this season. Rashawn Melvin, the tackle, it's a gain of 9.
Frankie Jackson, just from down the road, we were just talking about, from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, a true freshman. Showing the wheels.
So bring up second down and 7. Applin, complete. Stockamer the catch. Inside the 10. Down to the 1 yard line. Rashawn Melvin, a touchdown saving tackle, a gain of 37. First down and goal.
Taylor Stockamer just runs a quick slant route. Beats number 11, Rashawn Melvin, to the inside. Perfectly placed ball by Ryan Applin. Giving a ball he can keep running with. Get those yards after the catch.
Conklin now 6 for 8, 122. And Stockamer over 100 yards receiving.
Stockamer's their fastest receiver. You saw him showcase a little of that speed after he caught that football.
Applin, draw play to the end zone, touchdown. Tenth rushing touchdown of the year for Ryan Applin, and it has been all Arkansas State here in the opening quarter.
Ryan Applin's no slouch with his legs either. Very capable pulling it down. That time perfectly blocked up front. Just powers his way in for the touchdown.
And the Red Wolves with an interesting look as they set up for the extra point.
So many times they'll show you that just to keep the team honest, see if it's possibility to go for two. They obviously look for some sort of personnel mismatch.
Davis with the extra point. Quick drive for Applin and company. Three plays, 41 yards in under a minute.
Ryan Applin just did a good job showing pass, getting those linebackers dropped just enough, but nicely blocked up front. You see the pulling guard, number 63, Cliff Mitchell, leading the way. Tom Castellaw, his center, number 73. And so far, Arkansas State, like you said, Clay, has owned this game to this point.
Well, Northern Illinois does have a couple of starters out tonight defensively. We talked about Progar, suspended because of the DUI arrest on December 4th. And defensive tackle Ron Newcomb, injured his Achilles in the MAC title game. Potentially some guys being shuffled around over the last month, maybe contributing to this tough start for them.
You know, we asked Northern Illinois, we asked Jay Neiman about it. He said, you know, we've been rolling guys all season long at the defensive line position. But the impact that those players had that are out tonight, I think you're seeing that vulnerability on the defensive line. But I will say this for Northern Illinois, they're used to this situation. They've been bad. They don't get off to the strongest starts. They're not as balanced of a team. Their defense has struggled this year.
Salad's kick. Fielded inside the 10 by Tommy Lee Lewis. And he will be driven back at the 23. Let's go down to Kara.
Guys, offensive line coach Rod Carey absolutely chewed out the right side of the offensive line after that last series for the Huskies. Joe Pavlak, Keith Otis getting an earful. This senior-laden offensive line is part of what made this first-year coaching staff's transition so easy, but they're struggling early.
That is a very good offensive line when it's clicking. It hasn't so far tonight. Harnish back on the field. On first down. Penalty markers down. He goes deep. Down the middle of the field. Caught at the 43 and down to the 36 is Martell Moore, the number two receiver for the Huskies. But there is a flag.
I think it might stand. I think there might have been a neutral zone infraction.
Offside. Number 96 defense. Punch decline. Play was on the first down.
Huge play for Northern Illinois. They needed a big play. They needed it now. Chandler Harness provided a big throw.
His second completion tonight. First time in plus territory for the Huskies. First down and 10. Harness lost it. Low snap. It looks like he recovered. Loss of 5.
Just a low right snap. Those are tough to handle. Harness thankfully gets on it. Takes a lick from number 23, DeMario Davis. That could have been disastrous, though, for Northern Illinois, especially after they just got some momentum.
His center is Scott Wettage, a fifth-year senior. That doesn't happen very often to those guys. On second and 17, pressure coming from the right, and Harness got rid of it.
Chandler Harness
Once again, just trying to set up a screen. And we talked a lot about this offensive line. They've got four fifth-year starters up there. You'd expect them to play a lot better than they have tonight. They've got 160 combined starts amongst all of them. That's a lot of experience up front. It's really a reason this offense has clicked so much. But they've got to wake up and get into this game now.
Third and 15. Parnish, plenty of time. Nice catch. Nice play after the catch by Palmer, but he's going to be stopped short of the first down. Nathan Palmer, the fifth-year senior, leads the team in catches. He's the go-to guy in that situation.
Palmer right here. You see the ball just a little low, kind of double catches it. Presence of mind to know where he is on the field. And right here, Northern Illinois is going to go for it on fourth down.
Fourth down and three. Harnish down and in route to the 20. Wells makes the catch, and the Huskies keep the drive alive. Jamison Wells, also a star center fielder on the NIU baseball team.
That time, just a double slant route on the top for Chandler Harnish. Made a good read and a better throw. That shows how much trust and confidence they have in him there going for it.
Harnish handoff right up the middle, and a good run on first down. Cameron Bell, the fullback, picks up six.
Oh, we saw Northern Illinois, a little wishbone there, running the dive to big Cameron Bell. Nice push up front. Those offensive linemen been challenged. They're responding.
Harnish. Little or no room that time. And Brandon Joyner, probably the most disruptive Arkansas State defender. And the Sun Belt Defensive Player of the Year makes the stop. You see the first two drives, not much in the way of productivity. This drive, a lot better.
We talked about the fact that they have had 36 days off since their last game. Of course, it's going to take some time to get back in the rhythm of this game tempo.
Trying to convert. 0-for so far tonight on third down. Harnish on third and four. Pumps, goes to the end zone, incomplete. Well, contact in the end zone, no penalty flag. Good coverage in the secondary by Chaz Scales.
They try a double move here. See Willie Clark running a slant and go. Chaz Scales has none of it on the outside. Doesn't bounce. You see Chandler Harnish wants the pass interference call.
So Matthew Sims will come out. Try and get some points on the board for the Huskies. Two last-second game winners this year. He won the MAC title game with a 33-yard field goal. This from 32 for Northern Illinois. They fake it. It's a run. Still on his feet. Pat McAvoy. Did he get enough? It doesn't look like it. And Arkansas State is going to take over on downs.
Well, Northern Illinois trying to capitalize off the momentum that they had on that drive. Figured maybe they'd catch Arkansas State off balance. See, the holder gets it, flips it to the up back there, number 41, Pat McAvoy. There is a crease there. It's open, but boy, does Arkansas State close that gap.
This is going to depend on the spot, too. Now they're going to measure. Sure didn't look like he got him.
Oh.
Did not. They got it. They did get him. It was a better spot for Northern Illinois than originally thought.
Well, I think he got it off his initial momentum that got there, because then off that second effort, I think the officials probably went up and spotted it off that. There's a look where he needs to get to the yellow line. Boy, I don't know. Now, our line is not 100% accurate. But, man, that did look like he was stopped.
It
looks like Arkansas State might want to challenge this, too.
The initial spot sure looked like he didn't get it. the measurement showed otherwise. We've got a referee in the booth tonight, Jeff Flanagan from the ACC. And Jeff, your opinion?
Definitely a reviewable play. It's all a matter in the official's judgment if his forward progress was stopped at the point of the line of game.
McAvoy was stopped. And you can see where the line judge marked it.
Forward progress was ruled, and it is not reviewable. It is a first down.
Took us out of replay by ruling forward progress.
So that's exactly what we were talking about right before, was the fact that the officials probably marked the spot when the forward progress stopped. Even though it might have looked like it was short, it's not a reviewable play once they say forward progress.
Right? Correct. The officials ruled the forward progress was stopped. Therefore, the play's not reviewable.
Thank you, Jeff. He'll be with us all game. So Arkansas State looked like they made the stop. Instead, Northern Illinois keeps the drive alive.
Now the big question for Northern Illinois is, can they capitalize off the breaks they've gotten right on this drive? Converted a fourth down. They did that on their own. That one there, questionable spot on the ball. Can they capitalize with a touchdown?
And now timeout. Northern Illinois is going to call a timeout here.
Play game. Number 12 offense. 5-yard penalty. It remains first down.
They didn't get a timeout. Instead, it's going to be a delay game.
Another frustrating situation for a coach when you have all that time in between plays. It wasn't like they didn't have time to get the play called.
They were trying to get the timeout from the sideline, couldn't do it in time. So now first and 15. Harnish complete. Martell Moore inside the 10-yard line. Gain of 7. Don Jones makes the stop.
You know, you talked about so much about timing. That time was a perfect example. Martell Moore catching a little bubble screen pass. Didn't let his lineman clear for him out front. Actually ran into one of his linemen. Was supposed to be blocking for him. That play could have been much bigger.
Again, complete. Perez Ashford. They're going to rule him down. It looks like they're going to rule him down just outside of the end zone with under a minute to go here in the quarter. A gain of 8.
Perez Ashford ran a nice route on the outside. You saw him run slants before. That time showed slant, kind of stuttered, came back out to the outside. Take a look at that. Here's Harnish. See him looking that way the whole time. Ashford stretching out. And man, I tell you, this one looks like they might want to take a look at this one. Could be a touchdown.
Ashford had that huge catch in the MAC title game to set up the game-winning field goal. And it's going to be first down and goal to go for Northern Illinois.
Of a first down is under the review.
There's the stretch. Is there any knee down? He's got his entire body off the ground, and I think that ball crosses the plane of the goal line. I think this play might get ruled a touchdown. You see there, I think he's got the ball across the plane. There's the space underneath him. It's tough to tell from that angle, but you can almost tell by the shadows that the ball is clearly past that white line.
Right now the ruling is first down, goal to go for Northern Illinois. They are checking upstairs to see if Ashford indeed was in the end zone. A lot of things have gone right for Northern Illinois in this series. If they get a touchdown here, it would complete the change in momentum.
Yeah, this team, this Northern Illinois team, is so senior-laden on the offensive side of the ball. With all those offensive linemen we talked about, they don't panic at all. They don't care if they're down 13. They don't care if they're down 20 like they were in the MAC championship game. They just continue to execute. Here's one more look at Perez Ashford as he stretches for the end zone. I think it's pretty clear cut. I think this is going to be a touchdown for Northern Illinois.
Rosie Amato, Chuck Amato's brother, is the replay official tonight. You see Dave Gunn, the interim head coach.
I'm sure Chuck Amato is watching now that he's headed to the MAC, headed to Akron to coach with Terry Bowden.
And there's Dave Doran, first-year head coach for Northern Illinois, who's done a great job with this football team as well. He's a defensive guy by trade, but this offense has been very impressive. The main reason that Northern Illinois was able to put up 10 wins this season. Long time to take a look at this.
Yeah, you almost wonder typically in a long replay, they're deciding where to spot the football. But I would be surprised if this isn't ruled a touchdown. I mean, the only thing I could see them is saying maybe it's on the 3-inch line. I love how Perez Ashford stretched for that goal line, knew where it was, had the presence of mind to get upfield as soon as he got the ball in his hands. And what I think he kept his legs off the ground while he got the ball over.
Not down prior. There we have a touchdown. Leap reset. Game for 1 minute. 1-0-0.
It's a little cryptic there, but we got the message.
We may not be able to read lips, but that touchdown signal is universal. We know what that means. So there, the officials were in agreement with what we saw. It's good to see they got it right in Northern Illinois. Happier than anyone, they got the touchdown call.
Third touchdown of the year for Ashford. It's a big one for Northern Illinois as they're finally on the board. Sims comes on for the extra point. He nails that one. 13-7 now as Northern Illinois, which could muster only 13 yards of offense in its first two drives, marches it down and scores. Harnish to Ashford. That review took over 3 minutes, but they got it right.
That's right. Chandler's happy about it. Head coach Dave Doran likes it. There's always a big sigh of relief once you get that first touchdown of the game, especially when you've been off to a slower start. Chandler Harnish, what he did on that drive, 4-6. Looked like the fifth-year senior quarterback that was MAC Player of the Year on that drive. Still hasn't done much damage with his legs yet. And I think it's going to be a challenge for him tonight. I think Arkansas State has a game plan to stop him on the ground and make him win with the pass game.
Earlier this season, he had a 200-yard rushing game and a 200-yard passing game against Western Michigan. Only the 10th player ever to do that. Denard Robinson did it most recently ahead of him in 2010, but it gives you an idea of the kind of game he can have, and maybe that last drive is the sign of what's more to come here tonight.
Yeah, I mean, I firmly believe Arkansas State is going to try to take that aspect of Northern Illinois' offense away.
Tyler Wedel, the kick. And here comes Rod Hall from the 1 yard line for Arkansas State. Out across the 20 down to the 23 yard line. Well, tomorrow, ESPNU gets you prepared for the All-State BCS National Championship. At 3 Eastern, Palmer and Pollock will have their take on the game. At 4 Eastern, a 2-hour edition of BCS Countdown as the experts break it down. And then finally at 6, it's Sports Nation. College football lives on ESPNU tomorrow. We are the home of the BCS Championship coverage. All starts at 3 Eastern. I think there are going to be a lot of people staying home from work tomorrow to take it all in on TV. 54 seconds to go in the opening quarter. It has been entertaining to say the least. A running play here for Derek Lawson. He'll get a couple.
Now the challenge for Northern Illinois is going to be that front seven, especially those front four defensive linemen. Clay, we talked last time about the two impact players that are out of the game, and Ron Newcomb and Sean Progar. Those backups and other guys that don't play very much, they're going to have to step it up.
Second and eight. Applin will run. Lowers his head and gets out to about the 28-yard line. Nabal Jefferson, who's made a couple of tackles already in this series, coming off a terrific MAC title game, makes another tackle, also number 53. Pat Schiller in on the play as we're under 10 seconds to go, and Arkansas State will not get off another play here in the first quarter. Got a feel yet, Danny?
You know, they're both teams figuring each other out right now.
Arkansas State leads it after one, 13-7 at the GoDaddy.com Bowl in Mobile.
Oh, you didn't get a Miller Lite?
No, what's the difference?
Miller Lite has more taste.
I don't care, I just got one of these.
Well, that's the second unmanly thing you've done today.
What was the first?
Hey, guys! I'm on a scooter!
Unmanly.
Man up and choose Miller Lite. We add hops not once, not twice, but three times. Brewed for that great Pilsner taste.
Hey, Ricky!
We ride together. What's up?
It's your social network. All mixed together. With Galaxy Nexus by Samsung, now you can organize your contacts into circles, like you do in real life. So you can choose what people see and what they don't. And with the speed of Verizon 4G LTE, you can chat as a group in a Google Plus Hangout without missing a beat. Introducing the first phone built for Android 4.0, only at Verizon.
All the people, they're looking at me. 'Cause they see that I'm free. All the people, they're looking at me.
The SoundLink wireless mobile speaker. Bluetooth connectivity. Grab-and-go portability. With deep, rich sound you can only get from Bose.
At H&R Block, you could get money that's both fast and free on an Emerald Card. Just bring in your tax information and get a refund anticipation check in 7 to 14 days for up to $9,999. Call 1-800-HR-BLOCK to make an appointment.
Would you like her to rephrase the question?
I'm not going to be the person I'm expected to be anymore.
Bien expected. Bleu de Chanel.
At Chanel.com.
Why do we have Aflac?
Aflac!
And Major Medical?
Major Medical, boy! Yeah! I help pay the doctor. Ain't that enough for you?
There are things Major Medical doesn't do.
Aflac
pays cash so we don't have to fret.
Something families should get.
Like a safety net.
Even helps pay deductibles to cover your back with.
Help protect your family at Aflac.com.
The Go Board. Information you need, freedom to get going. At a value that's simply refreshing. And now the official hotel sponsor of the NFL. Courtyard, it's a new stay.
Northern Illinois won the MAC championship for the first time in 28 years with an amazing comeback over a month ago. Harnish. And complete inside the 10, and Palmer spinning, and they call it a touchdown. Harnish gonna launch it downfield. Catching it for the touchdown is Martell Moore. Harnish to the end zone. Touchdown, Nathan Palmer. And it just sneaks through. They finally break through. Northern Illinois wins the MAC. Danny, Northern Illinois trailed 20-0 at the half, so getting down 13-0 in this game, nothing for this team.
It's no big deal at all for them. I mean, I covered them earlier in the year against Ball State. Twice in that game, they were down 14. They came back to win.
Third down and 6. Make it third down and 5 for Arkansas State. They got it at their own 28-yard line. Applin sprinting out, throws on the run. Getting out of a tackle is Frampton, and he's got enough for the first down.
When you play these spread offenses, they want to get you in open space and make you tackle. That's exactly what happens here. You see the pass to the flat? You have to make that tackle if you're Northern Illinois, but a good job by Dwayne Frampton eluding that first contact and picking up the first down.
On first down, complete again. Earl Lucas, a redshirt freshman out of Prattville, Alabama. A lot of Alabama natives on this Red Wolves roster. And Jimmy Ward makes the tackle on that play.
This Arkansas State offense is fun to watch. They spread you, make you cover them sideline to sideline. Get all these athletes out into open space and make you form tackle. Yeah, there's a, that's going to be on the offense.
Someone's going to need to run to Radio Shack and get some batteries. Zach McKnight is the guilty culprit for Arkansas State, so they'll march it back 5. Third penalty tonight against the Red Wolves.
Second down and 12.
3 drives, 3 scores for Arkansas State. It's second and 12. One. That's caught by Stockerman. Get a handful. Rashawn Melvin. The corner is there to guide him out of bounds. It's a gain of 3 for Arkansas State. Third down and fairly long.
You see a lot of those short passes, those controlled. They kind of supplement the running game, but what they do is they lull you to sleep with several of those in a row, and then they take their deep shot down the field.
So Northern Illinois, which has a little momentum now, trying to get off the field here on third down. Huskies bring 4. Applin forced out of the pocket and being chased. Applin gets ahead but well short of the first down, and Arkansas State's going to have to kick.
A nice job in coverage from Northern Illinois. Ryan Applin had nowhere to go with that football. It is tough to cover for that long. Applin buying some time, scrambled to his left. It's always a challenge for a right-handed quarterback, but simply couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. So Northern Illinois, their defense responded to that momentum that the offense captured.
First punt of the night for Neely Sullivan. He averages 43 yards per kick. Check that, Wilburn on to punt, the rugby-style kicker. And Davis on the return, fair catch at the 22. Chandler Harnish in the NIU offense coming back out, down a score.
It's the Super GoDaddy girls.
Who's the small business owner without a domain name and a website?
It's expensive, right?
Wrong.
GoDaddy.com makes it totally affordable.
Besides, a small business without a website is like a superhero without a sidekick.
I thought you were the sidekick.
Anyway, we need to teach you a lesson.
See more now at GoDaddy.com.
You won't find the toughness of a Ram 1500 combined with the legendary power of a Hemi V8 in any other truck. It's a beautiful thing. Guts, glory, Ram.
Leadership.
excellence, performance. It's what Heisman and Aflac's all about. Aflac, an official partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Movie? Call, pack, kick back. That's all it takes to move your DirecTV. One call before moving, pack your receiver, and we do the rest. Just call, pack, kick back, and ask about 3 free months of our premium programming, plus our special equipment upgrade offer. So make your move easy. Call DirecTV.
With DirecTV Cinema, you can order Hollywood's biggest hits right from your mobile phone.
God bless technology.
God bless.
Simply text MOVIE to 223322 anytime from your mobile phone.
That makes things easier, huh?
Then type in the movie you want to watch or choose from a list of the hottest new releases.
Cool, huh?
There's no phone line or broadband connection required and no ordering fees.
Now you're talking.
The best of the big screen is only a text away with DirecTV Cinema. Text MOVIE to 223322 today.
ESPN College Football, the GoDaddy.com Bowl, is brought to you by GoDaddy.com, domains, websites, and everything in between, and Ram Trucks, guts, glory, Ram.
Looks like New Orleans, but it's not. We're in Mobile, Alabama tonight. The national title game is tomorrow night in New Orleans. But here, the GoDaddy.com Bowl sees Arkansas State on top of Northern Illinois 13-7. Bet you didn't know this. Mardi Gras actually started here, Danny Cannell.
Well, I actually did know that because we have some Mobile locals in our booth. And they did inform me of that. But I only learned it about five minutes before we came on air.
New Orleans gets all the credit for it, but it started here. First down and 10 for Chandler Harnish in Northern Illinois. Down a touchdown. 6-point deficit for the Huskies after they fell behind 13-0. Harnish pumps, goes deep, up the sideline. Nice adjustment and catch by Ashford. Already a touchdown for Ashford tonight. Another big play, a gain of 33.
So many teams run the bubble screen, watch it up top, and then they just run deep on the outside. Catch the secondary, peeking in, getting ready to come up and tackle that quick pass, take the shot over the top.
From the 44, first down and 10. Crossing route, complete, Moore. Lot of room to run. Nice cut. Inside the 15, down to the 12-yard line. And Harnish is limping.
Well, that is not a good sign for Northern Illinois, and he looks like he's in a lot of pain. He's better off here to go down on the field rather than come off the field, because now the backup quarterback's got to play right away. You stay on the field and go down. These are why your medical staff is evaluating your backup quarterback and get some snaps, kind of get loose, get warmed up.
We've already seen Jordan Lynch a couple of times tonight. After Harnish left with what appeared to be an equipment issue. He'll run inside the 10-yard line. Second down.
Number 6, Jordan Lynch with the long carrier.
Here's Chandler Harnish. Let's take one more look at it. See, after the pass, he looks like he gets rolled up by number 25 from Arkansas State, who's kind of around his ankles. See right there, just came down awkward after delivering the pass to Perez Ashford.
Second down for Jordan Lynch. Pretty good runner. Fourth on the team in rushing yards. Draw play. And he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. For Sean Lee, the middle linebacker, they call him Q, makes the tackle. So now third down. There's Jordan Lynch, a sophomore out of Chicago. He has played in 13 games now, so he's seen some activity. But the star of this offense is on his back on the sideline. Third and 6. Lynch in trouble and down. Brandon Joyner His 13th sack of the year. It's a loss of six.
Brandon Joyner is a difference maker on the defensive side of the ball. He's had an outstanding year, an outstanding career.
You don't want to go. You can't catch that.
The Sun Belt's Defensive Player of the Year. You see him, number 99, just power rushes right past number 68, Keith Otis, all the way to the quarterback. And at least for Jordan Lynch, didn't make a bad decision, just ate it, let his field goal kicker go out and do his job.
Sims, first team All-MAC, an attempt from 33 to make this a three-point game. No good. Missed it. No points, and potentially Northern Illinois has lost its starting quarterback. We'll find out. Back in a moment.
Here's why you need a domain name from GoDaddy.com. Because a domain name lets customers, family, or friends find you on the internet. And with every GoDaddy.com domain name, you get a free instant page website. Use your site to sell products or promote services. Post your resume, create a wedding site, then post photos and videos. Visit GoDaddy.com now to see more things domain names can be used for and get your very own. GoDaddy.com. Domains, websites, and everything in between.
Talking a big game about your engine is one thing. Having a proven history that can back it all up is a whole other story. Unsurpassed torque, incredible towing, legendary Cummins engines. Which engine do you want powering your truck? Guts, glory, Ram.
Laces? Really? Slip-on's the way to go. More people do that, security would be like a...
There's no charge for the bag.
Thanks. I know a quiet little place where we can get some work done is a three-pronged plug.
I have club passes.
Now there's a mileage card that offers special perks on United, like a free checked bag, United club passes, and priority boarding.
Thanks. Okay. What's your secret?
The new United Mileage Plus Explorer card. Get it and you're in.
Most irresistible burrito with crunchy flaming hot Fritos chips, premium seasoned beef, and nacho cheese sauce is back, and one is never enough. It's Taco Bell's 99-cent beefy crunch burrito.
Chandler Harnish, the player of the year in the MAC, is limping off to the Northern Illinois locker room.
And that is a crushing blow for Northern Illinois' offense. And he's the fifth-year senior. He's their leader on the field, but he's also their most productive player. And boy, I bet you nobody is more upset about this than Chandler Harnish.
A lot of folks think that he has a chance to play at the next level.
Yeah, a lot of the talk has been he'd be a fifth, sixth, seventh round pick. You know, I think he really wanted to showcase his talent tonight against an Arkansas State defense that a lot of people talk about, you know, being such a great test for him. And now it's up to Jordan Lynch, the backup, to come in, and he's got to rely on the seniors up front. Just go out there, do his job, go through his progressions, be smart with the football. The rest will take care of itself.
We're starting field position tonight for Arkansas State. They start at their own 20. Kendrick Murray goes in motion. Ryan Applin hands off to Jermaine Robinson. He is the number three tailback for the Red Wolves, brought down by Rashawn Melvin. And it's a gain of six, second down and four.
That time, Arkansas State just running the run game just to keep Northern Illinois honest.
Off his back foot, complete to Stockamer. Stockhammer having a great first half. Melvin took him out of bounds, but it's a gain of 17.
We saw the exact same action up front, same motion. It looked like they were going to give the ball again to the running back, but Applin kept it, took his shot down the field. It was well contested by number 11, Rashawn Melvin. Stockhammer just went and got it.
He's got 123 yards receiving on six catches. Robertson knifing his way into plus territory. Down to the 46-yard line. Jamal Bass brings him down, but another big play for Arkansas State as they move the chains.
Jermaine Robertson is a big back. He's 5'11", but he's 230 pounds. He is a load to bring down, and right Northern Illinois is struggling with that.
Applin. Fooled the defense a little bit, thrown down by Bass. And that's the thing, unlike Harnish, he leans more to the pass than run, but he is sneaky fast when you talk to his coaching staff.
Yeah, he really is. They talked about his athletic ability, the ability to make plays, and it's such an advantage for a play caller like Tyler Siskiyou, who's actually calling plays for the first time since he did it as a high school offensive coordinator. But when you've got a quarterback who really opens up your playbook with his legs, such an advantage.
Now being chased and dragged down. Alan Baxter with a sack of Applin. It's a loss of 13 yards.
Alan Baxter, number 90 for Northern Illinois. One of the guys that really need to step up with the absence of the playmakers on the defensive line. And right when Northern Illinois needed a big play, he got it for him. That's where his coaches said, Jay Neiman, his defensive coordinator, said he excels in the pass rush and passing situations.
Now we got a man slow to get up for Arkansas State. It's Josh Jarbo, the receiver. And he is up a long way from the Arkansas sideline. The trainers are out. And if you're just tuning in, Chandler Harnish, the starting quarterback for Northern Illinois, has already went to the Huskies locker room with what appeared to be a left ankle injury.
Sure, right now he's getting it examined further to find out if he can come back into this game, see if there's anything he can do, if he can take it, tape it up. Kind of secure it more so that at least he can take the field. But I think the biggest key when you're dealing with injury is find out, you know, is it going to worsen the injury or is it just a pain threshold?
So third and 21 now for the Red Wolves. Applin has hit his last five passes. Incomplete. Threw it at the feet of Jackson, who was well covered by Bass, and they will have to kick it away.
Both teams in these third and long situations have both tried to dial up screens, but both defenses well prepared. That time Northern Illinois sniffed it out right from the get-go. Applin had nowhere to go with the ball except throw it away.
Arkansas State will bring out Sullivan this time. Wilburn and Sullivan both punt. Sullivan is the traditional style kicker. Wilburn comes on for the rugby style kicks. Davis and Ashford back. And Davis calling for the fair catch. Chandler Harnish in the locker room. This offense under the guidance of Lynch now.
Why should you get a domain name from GoDaddy.com? Because a domain name lets you do so many things on the internet. Use yours to build a website, to promote services or sell products, post your resume, register your baby's name, create a wedding site, then post photos and videos to share with family. Visit GoDaddy.com now to see more things domain names can be used for and get your very own GoDaddy.com. Domains, websites, and everything in between.
Super Tuesday, Georgia, Florida at 7, Ohio State, Illinois at 9 on ESPN.
Why do we have Aflac?
Aflac!
And Major Medical.
Major Medical, boy, yeah! I helped pay the doctor. Ain't that enough for you?
There are things Major Medical doesn't do.
Aflac
pays cash so we don't have to fret.
Something families should get.
Like a safety net.
Even helps pay deductibles to cover your back with.
Help protect your family at Aflac.com.
NBA League Pass delivers the most NBA games with more ways to watch. Order now from DirecTV to follow your favorite players and your favorite team on your choice of screens. Watch on TV, online, or on your mobile device. One price gets you the most NBA games, plus free mobile access anytime, anywhere.
What a play! The fans are loving it!
Check out a free preview December 25th through January 8th. To order, call 1-800-GET-SPORTS or visit DirecTV.com/NBA.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
We need to know the scale of the epidemic.
1,000,000,000 sick. That's where we're headed.
When will we know what this is?
It's figuring us out faster than we're figuring it out.
Your wife is dead.
What happened to her?
They're setting up roadblocks.
People will panic.
Get away! Get away!
Contagion. Movie start at channel 125.
Back at Ladd People's Stadium in Mobile, Alabama. 7:39 to go before half in the GoDaddy.com Bowl. Arkansas State leads it 13-7. Northern Illinois behind in this game, and they've also lost their starting quarterback, Chandler Harnish, at least for the time being. So Jordan Lynch, the sophomore out of Chicago.
He's got the tough challenge of going against this Arkansas State defense. He's been very aggressive tonight.
Play fake, wants to throw, deep downfield, has a man, it is caught by Moore. Inside the 40-yard line. 41 yards on the hookup.
Boy, Martell Moore ran a great route, just ran straight down the field, a little wheel route out and up, but watch the adjustment right there, cut in front of the defensive back to catch that football. You've got to love a receiver who knows where he is on the field and goes and gets the ball.
Nice throw by Lynch. And now here's Womble. And a gain of a couple. Let's send it back to Ryan Burr in the studio for an update.
All right, guys, the divisional round is set in the National Football League as the Broncos get by the Steelers in overtime. Tim Tebow across the middle to Demaryius Thomas, who takes it 80 yards for the game winner in overtime. Tebow, 316 yards on 10 completions. The Broncos played the Patriots Saturday night.
How about that, Danny? I know you were glued to that game.
That was unbelievable. Huge game for Tebow.
Second down and 8. Lynch is complete to Ashford, and he takes a pop by Nigel Bird, the senior Sam linebacker.
This Arkansas State defense is bringing the wood tonight. Watch number 34. That's about as ferocious as a hit as you will see out there. And that's about the third one Arkansas State has delivered tonight.
Third down at 6. Penalty flags down. Caught. Getting out of a tackle is Ashford. Inside the 20. And down to the 16-yard line. Nathan Harrell the tackle, but there is a marker on the play.
I think this play is going to go against the defense here. Thought they might have jumped off sides.
Offside. Number 92 in the defense. That penalty is declined. The play resulted in a first down.
You prove a prophet one more time, Danny Cannell.
How about Jordan Lynch, though, on a critical third down, delivered a great throw to Perez Ashford on the outside, all the way across the field, a long throw. Perez Ashford, I love what he does when he catches the football, gets upfield.
Lynch just 23 career pass attempts coming into this game tonight. Spins and hands off to Hopkins. And he'll get one. He's still on his feet. Give him a forward progress. There's going to be a short gain, and now penalty flags all over the place.
Number 94, Markell Owens, just stripped the entire helmet. off of a Northern Illinois player. See Coach David Gunn not happy with that. The coaches do not want to. How about that sign, though? Chandler Harness coming back.
To the goal. Down.
Harnish is back on the sideline for Northern Illinois. We'll see how long it takes for him to come back in.
More importantly, with a hop in his step.
Yeah, he
doesn't
ran
look
out
phased
here
at all.
After the penalty, first down and goal. Jordan Lynch running the offense for now for the Huskies. Deep handoff. Hopkins straight up the middle. Inside the five, pushing the pile. Down close to the 3-yard line.
Boy, once Northern Illinois settled down offensively, they've really done a great job up front. The offensive line, which got chewed out earlier in the game after their first two drives, has done a much better job up front, providing run lanes for the running backs and also protecting their quarterbacks, whoever it is back there.
Second and goal from the 3. Lynch keeps, takes a hit, stays on his feet, touchdown! What a move by Lynch to cut back and score. And now Northern Illinois, an extra point for taking the lead.
What a huge run by Jordan Lynch. He is pumped up, and he should be. What a great second effort by the redshirt sophomore quarterback out of Chicago. Arkansas State had him tackled for a loss. Shed one tackler, put his nose down, and found the end zone.
And Northern Illinois has scored 14 unanswered points to take the lead with under 5 minutes to go in the half.
We've got a game on our hands.
Jordan Lynch, his 6th career rushing touchdown. The backup feeling it now.
Hello, we're delighted to welcome you to Mobile, a dynamic global city that holds a magical mixture of world-class entertainment, stellar museums, fine dining, and historic attractions. Join us for a journey through Mobile. We hope to see you soon in Mobile, Alabama.
Like so many great pioneers before me, guided only by a dream, I'm embarking on a journey of epic proportion. I will travel from sea to shining sea, through amber waves of grain, and I won't stop until I've helped every driver in America save hundreds on car insurance. Well, I'm out of the parking lot. That's a good start.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
If you're looking for a pickup truck, check out the miles per gallon, the length of the powertrain warranty, and the horsepower. Only Ram delivers this kind of muscle. That'll thin out the herd real quick. Guts, glory, Ram.
You think you're so smart? Here.
What am I supposed to find? What are the clues?
It was easy. This wouldn't be worth finding.
He was in the building on 9/11. I found this key in my dad's closet. I knew there was something he wanted me to learn.
You should give it a whirl, Oscar. It's time.
Dad was right, and he said not to ever stop looking.
Extremely loud and incredibly close. Rated PG-13. Now playing in select theaters. Starts everywhere January 20th.
Luck. I don't trade on luck. I trade on fundamentals.
Analysis. Information.
I trade on Trade Architect.
This is web-based trading revisualized.
Streaming real-time quotes.
Earnings analysis.
Probability analysis.
That's what opportunity looks like.
It's all visual.
Intuitive.
And it's available free.
Wherever the web is.
This is how trade strategies are built.
Trade Architect. Only from TD Ameritrade. Welcome to better.
Trade commission-free for 60 days when you open an account.
There's Jordan Lynch, the backup quarterback for Northern Illinois. And Chandler Harnish on the sidelines takes it in to cap the drive.
Here's one more look. Watch Jordan Lynch. He should be dropped by number 23, DeMario Davis, in the backfield, sheds that tackle, finds his way to the end zone, and he likes it.
Seven plays, 78 yards in under 3 minutes.
Pretty impressive performance for Jordan Lynch, coming off the bench cold. It's always tough for a backup. Sometimes you're better off when you don't know you're going to play. You don't know any better. Sometimes that naivete is a good thing.
But it looks like Harnish is going to be ready to go on the next Northern Illinois possession. Andrew Tryon, the freshman. It's a hard hit at the 25-yard line. Let's go down to Kara Capiano for more on Chandler Harnish.
Clay, as you said, it is a left ankle injury for quarterback Chandler Harnish. He will return in the game. And should note, after Jordan Lynch scored, head coach Dave Doran came all the way out to the 15-yard line to congratulate the young quarterback. So, as Danny mentioned, solid experience for the young man for next year, but Harnish should be back.
Dave Doran, the former Wisconsin defensive coordinator. Now, offense isn't his thing, but he appreciates good offensive play when he sees it.
Well, he loves the offense. He's been carrying them most of the year.
Bet. So here go the Red Wolves back to work. Applin throws, complete to the outside. Taylor Stockamer, who else? Another catch. That's his seventh on the day. Give him 9 more yards. Now, Arkansas State scored on its first 3 possessions. Northern Illinois has rallied. They've got the lead.
And now for Arkansas State, it becomes the challenge is now on their shoulders. Can they respond to the adversity they've faced?
Derek Lawson has not been called on a lot tonight, and the running game is stacked up. And has enough for the first down. Lawson was a record-setting high school running back at Nettleton High School right there in Jonesboro. He's a local hero. First down and 10 for Arkansas State.
Arkansas State hasn't taken a shot in a while.
Applin complete again. Dwayne Frampton. It's across the 40, tackled by Jimmy Ward, who's playing in his hometown tonight. Ward, a Mobile native. 30 high school games, he says, he played thereabouts in this stadium, so he knows this turf very well. And now Frampton is limping. Wait, it's been a hard-hitting game.
Yeah, it really has. We've seen several players with injuries tonight. We've got a couple conference champions going at it. A lot of seniors on the field for what could be their last game ever if they don't play at the next level. You see the passion out there. They're letting it all hang out in the field tonight.
Dwayne Frampton set team records with 90 catches and over 1,100 receiving yards this season. Senior out of Wilmington, California, he is being attended to.
Well, he's had a phenomenal year. He's been Ryan Applin's favorite target.
Under 4 minutes to go before halftime, and for what's coming up at the half, let's go to the studio and Ryan Burr.
Thanks a lot, Clay. Coming up on the H&R Block Halftime Report, I'll be joined by Joey Galloway, the Tim Tebow legend. Gets another chapter as Tebow leads the Broncos to a thrilling victory. We'll look ahead to tomorrow's BCS national title game between LSU and Alabama, hear from both coaches. And Joey tells us what both teams have to do in order to walk away with the crystal ball tomorrow night in New Orleans. All coming up on the H&R Block Halftime Report. Guys, we'll see you in a few.
All right, sounds good, Ryan.
I imagine we'll see a little bit of Tim Tebow on SportsCenter this week.
Oh, yeah. No question about it. Here's another look at the play that has Frampton down on his back.
Boy, that was an awkward angle. His knee came down on right when he got hit by Jimmy Ward.
That's a good sign. He's putting some weight on it. Well, here's how we've gotten to this point. Ryan Applin scoring the first touchdown for Arkansas State after a couple of field goals. Chandler Harnish then throwing a touchdown pass to Perez Ashford as the Huskies get on the board. And then with Harnish in the locker room being looked at with an ankle injury, leads the team on a touchdown drive, and he caps it.
Yeah, I mean, it's been just a momentum shift. First, it started off all Arkansas State. They were pretty much owning the game. And then lately, Northern Illinois responded with 14 unanswered points.
Second down at 5. Applin gives it to Robertson. And the ball, Jefferson wraps him up. Gets one on the play, so third down, about 4 to go. They send 3 receivers to the right. Northern Illinois brings 4, quick release, incomplete. Intended for Earl Lucas, number 83. And it'll be a kicking situation again.
And that pass typically would have been intended for Dwayne Frampton, who just left the field. That time, it's redshirt freshman Earl Lucas, number 83. You saw just the timing was a little off between he and Ryan Applin.
There's Frampton on the sideline. This is a third straight drive for the Red Wolves that has ended in a punt. The momentum has certainly shifted from the first quarter. Tommy Davis hangs with it on the fair catch. Now Super Tuesday begins this week on ESPN. Action begins in the SEC at 7 Eastern when Georgia faces Kenny Boynton and 14th-ranked Florida. And at 9 Eastern, Jared Sellinger leads Ohio State against Illinois. Super Tuesday presented by KFC on ESPN. Florida, where they're a hot shooting team, especially from the outside, leading the nation in three-pointers. Average 11 per game. So here's Chandler Harnish. Back out on the field for Northern Illinois. 3 minutes to work with. His team up by a point in the flat, dropped. Are they going to say that was a lateral? No, they're going to call it incomplete.
They're going to call it incomplete, but I think that was a pretty wise move by the running back. Number 23 for Northern Illinois.
It's late and settled.
I mean, I think that was an aware play. You just have to make sure because you never know which way that call could go. It's interesting for me to watch Chandler Harnish, how it affects him throwing the football. Is he going to be able to transfer his weight? We saw it in the playoffs today. Ben Roethlisberger, the way he was affected with his ankle injury. We'll have to see how it affects Chandler Harnish.
Play fake. Nothing downfield. Steps up to run. And a gain of 4. Again, Harnish, such a good runner. Manages 4 on that.
Well, he wanted to pass that one. They were trying to take a big shot down the field off the play action. Sticks it into the read zone, but then he drops back, but there's nowhere to go with the ball, so he tucks it and keeps it. But I think, that's just, he's going to be a little bit slower, obviously, because he's got issues with the lower half of his body.
I got to tell you, though, there's a pretty good spring in his step.
No, compared to when he walked off the field without his shoe, no doubt.
3rd and 7. Northern Illinois has converted only once tonight on 3rd down. Akeem Daniels in the backfield with Harnish. Play clock under 10. Pressure from the outside. Got rid of it. Incomplete. Martell Moore, the intended receiver. Chaz Scales, another good play on defense for the Red Wolves.
Well, there was a lot of contact on that play by number 25, Chaz Scales. You see him meet Martell right there. Pretty good defense, though, staying right with the defender. I think the contact was early enough, and then he let go of him and made a good break on the ball.
Scales getting the start tonight because their number one corner at that spot, Deron Edwards, academically ineligible for this game. So he's stepping it up. Ryan Meir comes on to punt. Rod Hall back to return for Arkansas State. This is the 3rd punt tonight for the Huskies. Low snap. near able to get it off. Fair catch called for, dropped. Who's got it? Northern Illinois. Big break on special teams for the Huskies. Dominique Ware with a big play.
Watch out for Rod Hall. The punt returner had to run to catch this punt. He's running almost full speed. Then he realizes at the end, I got to get over there. It just lets the ball go right through his arms.
Rod Hall is not the regular punt returner. That's Dwayne Frampton, who got hurt not that long ago for Arkansas State, and it comes back to bite the Red Wolves.
That's the second play that's really had an impact. Earlier we saw a third down pass where the backup receiver couldn't come up with a catch. That time there, it's the backup punt returner.
We see Frampton. First turnover tonight, and Northern Illinois trying to capitalize. Hopkins tackled almost immediately after the catch by Starson and Lee.
Northern Illinois would like nothing more than to finish this half with a touchdown. They've already grabbed the momentum of this game, but if they can really capture it here at the end of the first half.
Second down and 7. Harnish, deep, has a man incomplete, intended for Pullman. And Don Jones was in coverage to bring up third down and 7.
Nathan Palmer, one of the toughest things for a do is for a receiver to adjust. Watch him has to flip his head all the way back around. Tough to find the ball when you take your eyes off of it, but he almost came up with it.
And now Jones is slow to get up, and he's holding his leg.
Some of these guys, the way they're grounded, you wonder if they're cramps. I mean, but it's here's one more look just out of Nathan Palmer's hands, and there's a look at number 5, Don Jones. In coverage, you don't see anything except his reaction that shows you that he's hurt. Let's say this, it's unseasonably warm here in Mobile.
Yeah, I wonder if cramping is...
Now, it's still early, too. I don't think that's the issue. He is still limping. Typically a cramp, they do that stretch, so it's hard to guess. You don't want to guess at an injury. But in any case, it's another player down. We've seen our share of players had to go to the sideline.
So now a 3rd and 7 for Northern Illinois. They've got it at the 40 of Arkansas State. Field goal kicker Matthew Sims has a long of 44 this year.
3rd down and 7.
He only converted once tonight on 3rd down. Low snap. Harnish brings it up. A little pressure, got rid of it, incomplete. Moore coming across was the intended receiver. There is Scales coming in with the pressure. And Harnish had to get rid of it quickly.
Boy, the corner blitz comes from the top, and he's got Chandler Harnish dead in the rights, but runs right by him, just whiffs on Harnish. The left tackle got just enough of him, maybe rerouted. But, man, it looked like it was going to be a big sack for Arkansas State.
So near to punt, and Andrew Tryon standing at his own 10-yard line. Just over a minute to go here at the GoDaddy.com Bowl. We're in the first half. And another fair catch called for, and another penalty flag down. Neer is down, and might be a roughing call here on the kicker.
That's where the flag is. I think it is going to be it.
A kick. 91 defense. 15 yards from the previous line of scrimmage. First down.
Thanks on Timothy Starson for Arkansas State.
What a huge turn of events for Northern Illinois. Another great break they've gotten in this game. Watch number 91. At the end of this play, watch number 91 coming to your screen. That's blocked, and just you've got to find a way. He knows that he's trying to catch the punter on the way down.
On top of that, it was looked like it was helmet to helmet. He banged into his helmet.
He did get sort of blocked into him. Either way, he's getting an earful from his coaches.
New life for Northern Illinois. Harnish steps up, tries to get behind a blocker. And he stood up after about a yard pickup. Joiner there, number 99. There is Dave Doran, the first-year head coach for Northern Illinois. He has three timeouts to work with here with 45 seconds to go in the half.
Chandler Harness is as tough as they come, but you got to wonder, do you want him to call these quarterback runs for him, knowing that could stress his ankle, which is already aggravated?
Ball at the 24-yard line. Harness, that might have been tipped at the line, yeah. Incomplete, third down and eight. Joiner again making the play.
Brandon Joiner just recognizing the quick pass, see him right at the left side of your screen. Sees it, gets that left hand up just enough of the ball. Pretty alert pass rusher to recognize. He's not gonna have a chance for the sack, so I might as well get my hands up and block it down.
Harnish now 0 for his last five. Third down and eight. 23 seconds to go here in the first half. Harnish pumps, throws, man open, and caught by Perez Ashford at the 9-yard line. Timeout, Northern Illinois, with 16 seconds to go. We're going to take a quick timeout, too. Back here in Mobile in a moment.
So I feel like everybody here is here for the students. This was just so welcoming and so comforting that I felt like this was where I was supposed to be.
Rather than trying to be an instructor, I try to be a guide to help them improve their understanding of what they're learning.
You can find everyone here at NIU, and it's a great model of what the real world is.
The student, the learner, is the center of our universe.
That ankle is probably still a little tender for Chandler Harnish, but he has looked good since getting back on the field.
Now watch this route by Perez Ashford. Watch him attack this linebacker, then just a little juke move to get behind him. The linebacker bites on the first one. Whoops. Right behind him, perfectly placed ball. And Perez Ashford tonight has had quite a game.
Yes, he has.
And he's been Chandler Harnish's go-to guy for most of the night. Had the touchdown early. He stretched it in for. It's a big catch there.
Six catches, 79 yards, and a touchdown for Ashford. Sets up first and goal. 16 seconds to go before half. Play clock at 5. Harnish to the end zone. Incomplete. He was looking for Palmer. Second and goal.
Well, last time we saw Perez Ashford set up the defender, and that's what Nathan Palmer needed to do on that one. See number 81 in the slot, just run straight for the post. He could have set up number 40. Nathan Harrell for Arkansas State a little bit better, gave him a head move to the outside and set it up. You can't just run routes. You've got to set them up, set the defender.
Second and goal with 12 seconds to go before half. Harnish. Complete. Caught at the 5. Diving to the end zone as Wells. Ball comes loose. They're going to rule it down. And a timeout again, Northern Illinois, with 6 seconds to go. They mark it down at the 1.
Early on the field, the rule was down. Just short goal line. It was not a touchdown. We have second timeout, Northern Illinois. It's a 30-second timeout.
And they have one remaining.
Almost an identical stretch for the end zone by Jamison Wells. He just runs an underneath route. Once again, as soon as he gets it, pushes vertically, and he's clearly short. You'll see them get the ball on about the 6-inch line, maybe half-yard line. Just short of that end zone. But man, I love how these Northern Illinois receivers have a nose for that end zone.
Yeah, we saw Ashford do that, as you mentioned, and they've got a lot of depth at that position. Palmer, Moore, Ashford, Deron Brown, who hasn't been busy tonight, but he is a good one too, and Wells, like we said before, is a two-sport athlete in DeKalb. Great center fielder in the springtime. Ninth play of the drive coming with 6 seconds to go. Third down and goal for the Huskies. Harnish changes the play.
He's gonna run it.
That was a whole lot of window dressing right there.
And the last timeout.
Timeout call. Arkansas State.
No, it's Arkansas State's timeout. And they're going to talk about what they expect to see coming.
What you saw there, Clay, was Chandler Harness doing his best acting job. He went out there, he was signaling to both sides. Look at him, signaling to the right, hey, we're going to run this pass right. Then he goes over to the left, we'll run this. But all the time, he knew he was going to run that quarterback sneak. You're trying to get the defense to widen out to those routes so you can catch them off guard. Arkansas State said, hey, what's going on? This doesn't look normal. We'll go ahead and call a timeout. Talk about this.
Well, even though Arkansas State called that timeout, Northern Illinois has time to talk about what they're going to run here with 6 seconds to go. What do you expect?
You know, that time they clearly used up their ammo right there, even though they didn't get to run the play. You know, they've got one chance at it. They can take a shot at the end zone, but they have to be quick with it. They can't have a play where Chandler Harness is scrambling around in the backfield because 6 seconds, you know, that time will run out. So they can try some sort of quick pass to the end zone is all they're going to have time for, I think. Of course, they got the timeouts. So they could even try to run one like they were thinking about doing. I mean, they were going to try to run that quarterback sneak. They think they get in here in a jumbo set and either run a quarterback sneak or some sort of running back run up the middle. Just try to power it in. If you don't get it, call timeout right away.
There's zero on the stadium clock. We know that not to be true. We think there are 6 seconds remaining. And Harnish comes up to the line on third down. Handoff. Hit. Hopkins did not get in.
Pretty good tackle by Don Jones right there, number 5, coming off the edge. He wraps him up.
And Northern Illinois calls its final timeout. With time on the clock, we believe it to be 2 seconds remaining in the half.
And that's a case there where Dave Doran is over in the official's ear on the sideline saying, hey, if we don't get this, as soon as that play is whistled dead, I want a timeout called so you don't risk it in any way.
So fourth down and goal will be the final play of the first half. Northern Illinois could add to its lead here, up a point. They fell behind in this game 13-0.
Interesting here on fourth down and short. They're going to go for it. And you would expect this. You've got 4 fifth-year seniors on the offensive line. You've got to say, hey, guys, up front, you have got to figure a way to get this ball in the end zone. It's a lot of experience up front.
Womble is the deep back. Harnish gives it to Womble. Touchdown, Jamal Womble. He is the biggest tailback for Northern Illinois at 5'11", 247 pounds. And it's his first career touchdown. It's a big one.
Wow, what a complete momentum shift for Northern Illinois.
Yeah. answered for Northern Illinois.
Watch the pull right here coming at you. Number 70, Logan Pegram up front. One of those offensive linemen that have such a big year for Northern Illinois. They put it on the big boys' shoulders and they came through.
Let's go down to Kara Capuano.
Coach, 21 unanswered points for Northern Illinois. How did that momentum change?
Well, we just started to execute. We were hurting ourselves early in the first quarter there. Defense did a good job after they settled down, and it's just execution for our kids. We just got to do what we do and do it better.
We know Chandler Harnish isn't at 100% because he had to go to the locker room. What is his status?
He's 100%. This is the last game he'll play as a senior. Here's a Husky. He's playing.
How much did he give you the confidence to go for it there on fourth?
Oh, the O-line's the deal. I mean, those guys, there's no way I could walk in that locker room if we didn't go for it.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, you bet.
Can't walk into the locker room without going for it, guys.
That's right. You touched on it, Danny. That O-line, the reason they're able to bang it in on the last play before halftime. 21-13, Northern Illinois. Now to the studio and Ryan.
All right, thanks, guys. Welcome into the H&R Block Halftime Report. Northern Illinois up 21-13 in the GoDaddy.com Bowl. Ryan Burr, former Ohio State great Joey Galloway, also spent centuries, it seems, in the National Football League. So we'll get to that BCS game tomorrow between LSU and Alabama in a second, but let's start with what everyone's talking about, Joey, and that would be Tim Tebow and the Denver Broncos. All we heard all week was he couldn't throw the ball. Playing against the NFL's number one pass defense, Tebow keeps it. Broncos lead 14-6. But the Steelers get back in the game. Willis McGahee puts it on the turf. Lamar Woodley recovers. Ensuing possession, Ben Roethlisberger, bad ankle at all, finds Jericho Cotchery.
Big play right here. This is Ben's type of play. Get out of the pocket, make a play, bad ankle, throw it up end zone, make a play. That's Pittsburgh Steeler football.
And the game is tied at 23. Denver had led 20-6. The Steelers come back, got to midfield at the end of regulation. We go to overtime. Overtime, Joey, one play, Tebow, Demaryius Thomas, ball game.
Pittsburgh known for their defense. What a surprising play to give it up this quickly in overtime.
So John Elway on the field, Tim Tebow, 29-23, the Broncos moving on.
When I saw them scoring, first of all, thank you, Lord. And then I was running pretty fast, chasing him, like I could catch up to DT. And, you know, then I just jumped in the stands. First time I've done that, but that was fun. And then just got on a knee, thanked the Lord again, and tried to celebrate with my teammates and the fans.
So take a look at what we have next weekend. And just real quick, Joey, you do know what we are in store for the next 6 days here leading up to Tebow versus Brady, don't you?
Get ready for Tebow. Get ready for Tebow 24-7.
At Tebow Mania. On Saturday, it will be the Broncos visiting Tom Brady and the top-seeded Patriots. New England has lost three consecutive playoff games. On Sunday, Texans look for their first ever win over the Ravens. Baltimore is in the playoffs for a fourth consecutive season. When we come back, we'll turn our attention to the NFC and turn our attention to that little game tomorrow night in New Orleans. For all the marbles, the rematch, number one LSU, number two Alabama, the biggest rematch in BCS history. We're back after this.
Everyone, meet our new GoDaddy girl, America's toughest trainer, Jillian Michaels. I am so pumped to be on the team.
Yeah, us too. We were just registering your domain name.
I just love how fast and easy it is to get a domain and a website at GoDaddy.com.
Oh, totally, yeah.
Okay, well, let's continue with the rest of our tour. I'm gonna go back in. See what happens next at GoDaddy.com.
Leadership, excellence, performance. It's what Heisman and athletes.
producer of the NFL. Here we go. Looking good, dog.
This halftime report is presented by H&R Block. Never settle for less.
What to watch for tomorrow night, the Allstate BCS National Championship game, 8:30 on ESPN. Number one LSU, number two Alabama. LSU won in overtime earlier this season. College game day begins at 6. Wendy Nix caught up with both coaches.
Given the probability there won't be a lot of huge plays Monday night, from the way we've seen these two teams play before, what is your appetite for taking risks?
Well, I do think that the misconception about this game, though, is, even though there's two outstanding defenses, is both teams have very explosive players on offense. And I'm concerned about how well we play defensively so they don't make explosive plays against us on special teams or with their offensive players or making big plays with their defense. So I think because there's such good players on both teams, that there's a lot of capability for those plays. They didn't get made in the first game, but that doesn't mean there's not going to be an opportunity for a lot of those kind of plays to be made in this game.
What is your biggest fear for Monday night?
The only thing I want to have happen is have our guys play like they play. If they make the plays that they came to make, if they enjoy the play like they have, these games that have led to this championship game, that's what I want to have happen. As long as our guys can execute and play like LSU, that's all I need to have happen.
So it's what we've been waiting really all of December and now into January for. It's one game for all the marbles. It's a rematch of a 9-6 overtime defensive struggle between Alabama and LSU. Let's play a little game of what if with Joey Galloway. What does Alabama have to do to win this game?
I think Alabama has to find help for Trent Richardson. I think that offensively, A.J. McCarron has to make a play, whether it's outside with Marquise Mays, maybe Darius Hanks, tight end Brad Smelly. Someone has to make a play. And the first time around, Trent Richardson, 170 yards of total offense, led the team in rushing and led the team in receiving. Have to find him help to make a big play.
Conversely, on the other side, LSU has already beaten Alabama once this season. LSU wins again if...
They got to get off to a faster start. They started this trend their last two games of the season. Early on, they're down 14-0 to Arkansas in the last game of the season. They go to the SEC championship game and get down 10-0 to Georgia. They have to fix this problem. They will not be able to come back versus this tough Alabama team if they get down. They need to get off to a fast start.
Now, LSU has been a dominant program this year. They beat Oregon, who went on to win the Rose Bowl. They beat West Virginia, went on to beat the Orange Bowl. They beat Alabama once already on their home field. Prediction time, Joey Galloway. It's the moment of truth here. Alabama, LSU, the rematch for the whole ball of wax. Who do you got?
I like Alabama. And I think the first time around, Jordan Jefferson was on the bench. Jarrett Lee started the game for LSU. Jordan Jefferson came in the game, sparked LSU's offense, and got them going. This time around, Nick Saban, defensive coordinator Kirby Smart, has had over a month to prepare for Jordan Jefferson and this LSU offense. I think they'll do a much better job of shutting them down. I think Alabama wins this game.
More points, higher scoring. We heard Coach Saban say he thinks the offenses are capable of doing more. Another single-digit game, or are you looking for some more offense?
Definitely more offense. We couldn't have any less. I do know that. So I'm looking for more offense in this game, more points for sure.
That is true. Once again, College game day starts at 6 o'clock tomorrow, the game 8:30 on ESPN. Game we're watching right now, it's a good one. Northern Illinois up 21-13 on Arkansas State. We're back after this.
I can tell you about Detroit. It's not what it used to be, unfortunately.
It's tough, you know, and I actually had to move back in with my parents.
And I heard about Second Loop on the radio.
They look at your taxes from last year and see if they can get you more money back.
Any money back from the government would help right now.
Ready for the results?
$1,135.
$2,560.
$8,600.
H&R Block. Never settle for
less. It's the perfect time to find great deals on the 4G LTE devices you love. Like the Droid Bionic by Motorola for $199.99. Or the Pantech Breakout for $49.99. Our lowest price ever. Get the technology you love on the network you deserve. Now get twice the data for the same low price. Hurry in. This offer ends January 15th. Verizon.
You know those lucky dogs who have that perfect amount of gray hair that everyone loves? Now you can be one of them. Touch of Gray combs away a little gray without getting rid of it all. Touch of Gray. Get the best of both.
When you book with Orbitz, you know you're getting the lowest price. Because only Orbitz has price assurance.
If someone on Orbitz books for less, you get a check for the difference automatically. When you Orbitz, you know.
NCAA and DonorsChoose.org are working together to put academic and athletic supplies back into our schools. And you can join the NCAA in supporting the needs of teachers' projects. From athletics to academics, find out how you can help future student-athletes at ncaa.org/fundthefuture.
Welcome back to the H&R Block Halftime Report.
Brian Burr back with Joey Galloway. Take a look at the Falcons and the Giants, Joey. And Mike Smith looking for his first playoff win. Fourth and one, not once but twice, goes with a Matt Ryan sneak. Both times, Ryan does not make it. Giants take over on downs. Now, you know a little thing about receiving in the National Football League. 16 years an NFL player, Eli Manning to Hakeem Nicks. 72 yards later, it's a touch.
Usually they're not that open. Wide open receiver, long touchdown.
Six catches, 115 yards, two touchdowns. Giants win 24-2. Falcons able to push across a run there in the bottom of the ninth. Taking a look at next weekend, you get the Saints on the road at San Francisco. San Francisco looking for their first ever, or the Saints looking for their first ever road win on Sunday. The Packers host the Giants. Of course, the Packers beat the Giants 38-35 on a last-second field goal in Week 13. GoDaddy.com Bowl. Brian Davis with the touchdown. Northern Illinois up 21-13. Joey and I back after this.
When it comes to home insurance, surprises can be a little scary.
And a little costly. That's why the best agents present their clients with a lot of options.
Because when it comes to what's covered and what's not, nobody likes surprises.
We totally thought you were.
Obscure space junk falling from the sky? We covered that. Moving on.
We are insurance.
We are farmers. Bum, ba, bum, 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 bum.
Tostitos, I heard you were a football star.
It's true. Check it out. So, championship game, I get the ball, I'm in the clear, and that's when I heard the pop. Ugh. Blew out my bag.
You could have gone pro.
I'd never play another down.
Aw, Tostitos.
Hey, listen, it's okay. Look, I partied my way through school, I got an education, and I still got the Fiesta Bowl named after me.
What's that?
That's my touchdown dance, sweetheart. Boom.
Touchdown! You're a funny bag.
I'm a party bag.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real, naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free, no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 1-800-205-0513. That's 1-800-205-0513.
Conference play is here. Big Monday coming up. West Virginia, UConn. UConn, the defending national champs. Little appetizer to the BCS national title game. That's 7 o'clock tomorrow on ESPN2. Big Ten baskets tonight. Wisconsin taking on Michigan. Michigan undefeated at home this year. And it would be a big day for Tim Hardaway Jr. knocking down the three. Hardaway had 17 and 10 for Michigan as they start to pull away here in the second half. A steal by Michigan. Trey Burke ends up with it. He lays it up and in. Michigan goes on to win 59-41. Now, team, I know you're passionate about. That would be Indiana. Coach O'Brien, standing ovation from the Penn State crowd. But how about this Indiana team? Took out Ohio State at home. I know you're impressed with the Hoosiers there.
Yeah, I am impressed. And we get another shot coming up on the 15th. We'll get them back.
You get them back. Okay. Indiana now, 15-1 on the year, 88-82. Hoosiers win. Game we're watching right now, Perez Ashford the touchdown. It's 21-13 Northern Illinois. Second half action from the GoDaddy.com Bowl. Next.
This halftime report is presented by H&R Block. Never settle for less.
My son actually called me at work and said that H&R Block is taking a second look at your taxes and I think you should go in.
And so you did not claim their tuition at all?
No. If I got some unexpected money, we would probably pay off some bills and save the rest.
H&R Block, never settle for less.
If you have gout and think a few attacks a year are all you have to worry about, think again. Fact is, gout can attack silently even between flares. You may not feel it, but gout's root cause, high uric acid, can allow crystals to continuously form and build up in your joints. Over time, this may lead to attacks in other joints, constant pain, and joint destruction. So don't wait. Get more information at goutinfo.com and talk with your doctor about ways to keep your uric acid at a lower, healthy level.
Dear NFL football, do you know what love is? Love is turning your pickup truck into a pirate ship. Love is cold Bud Light on a crisp afternoon. It's turning a parking space into a party space. Love is loving that every Sunday is our Sunday.
Bud Light, proud to be the official beer sponsor of the NFL. Here we go.
Because love is a beautiful thing.
You have Mallory Kane.
Only reason we came to you.
She was the most trusted agent.
I have an assignment. It's like a paid holiday.
Until they made her their next target.
Mallory. The story will be that she's gone rogue.
Tell me now why you sold me out. Or you can tell me when I have my hands around your throat.
Fix it. Haywire.
Rated R.
In theaters January 20th.
I want to make a difference through medicine.
I want the knowledge to heal people.
The lifelong lessons I learned at ASU prepared me to make a difference in the lives of others.
A university education should empower you to achieve your dream.
My dream is to own my own marketing company.
I want to be a network news anchor.
ASU empowered me with the skills I needed to accomplish my dreams.
Welcome back to the 2012 GoDaddy.com Bowl from Mobile, Alabama. 21-13, our score at the half, Northern Illinois on top of Arkansas State. Alongside Danny Cannell, I'm Clay Matvick. Glad to have you along on a beautiful January night on the Gulf Coast. And it was a good start for Arkansas State. Jump out to a 13-0 lead, but then Northern Illinois, even though they lost their starting quarterback Chandler Harnish for a couple of series because of an ankle injury, they come storming back and they have the lead going into the second half.
This Northern Illinois team has so many seniors on the offensive side of the ball. Four of their five starters in the offensive line, fifth-year seniors. Chandler Harnish, fifth-year senior. But even when Jordan Lynch had to come in off the bench at quarterback, no drop-off. They've got to like what the future holds at the quarterback position as well.
All right, let's take a look at our expert breakdown brought to you by Farmers Insurance.
Well, in order for Arkansas State to get back in this game, they've got to take deep shots like they did here early in the first quarter. Have a look at the secondary. They're creeping up. They're getting involved in the run game. they get their big deep threat, Taylor Stockamer, on the deep post off the flea flicker play action. These are the types of things Arkansas State needs to do. They've thrown mostly underneath controlled routes, but they've got to loosen up the secondary for Northern Illinois as well. They can get the ground game going. They haven't been able to rush the football either. If they can get that ground game going, they can open up that play action pass once again.
All right, let's go down to Kara.
Guys, David Gunn's primary message to Arkansas State was to settle down. He said that the Red Wolves made uncharacteristic mistakes, and they really helped the Huskies gain momentum in that second quarter. A couple of key injuries of note. Taylor Stockamer had his right ankle taped. They were working on it. He is expected back, but Dwayne Frampton is not expected to return for Arkansas State.
Two key receivers for Arkansas State. In fact, Stockamer had 132 yards receiving in that first half, his first career 100-yard receiving game. So that's a big loss if he's slowed at all. And Frampton, of course, we saw what happened to him in the first half.
Yeah, well, I think Frampton being out is going to hurt them. And I think if you're Taylor Stockamer, you've got to watch what Chandler Harness did on the other side of the ball. You've got to tape that injury up and try to get out there and perform. He had two huge plays. He's their deep threat.
Northern Illinois, which had all of the momentum late in that first half, and get the ball to start the second half. Zalib kicks it inside the 10. Here comes Tommy Lee Lewis for the Huskies across the 25 and driven down at about the 27-yard line. Neither team rushing the ball particularly well in that first half.
No, I mean, really, these teams have combined for 36 rushing yards tonight. On the season, they averaged 412 rushing yards per game. Those teams combined for that average. So both of these games, these teams would be well served to try to get their rush attack going.
That left ankle taped up probably again during the halftime for Chandler Harnish. First down and 10 for the Huskies. First play of the second half. Play fake. Harnish going deep. Looking for Palmer. Intercepted. Picked off by Chaz Scales.
Number 25, Chaz Scales, has had quite the game for Arkansas State. Watch the play by number 25. Boy, he just takes the ball right out of Nathan Palmer's hands. I mean, that ball was in pretty good placement for Nathan Palmer to come down for it for Northern Illinois. Chaz Scales just wanted it more.
Again, starting tonight because Deron Edwards is out, being academically ineligible, and he is making the most of his start. Arkansas State has it now. First and 10 at their own 32. Jackson. Down by Rashawn Melvin. Gain of 5.
It's well documented this Arkansas State offense is very balanced. They run the ball well and they pass the ball well, but tonight they've been pretty lopsided toward the pass.
This time Jackson nowhere to go. There's Nabal Jefferson, who had a terrific MAC title game. He had 6 tackles. He was pretty good in the first half here tonight, too. Starts off the second half with a good stop. Third down.
His coaches raved about his performance, said he laid it all on the line, threw everything into that MAC championship game.
Arkansas State yet to get to 200 yards of total offense tonight. 453 on average coming into the game.
Northern Illinois defense all standing up. Really tough to identify who to block.
Here comes the pressure. Applin tipped up and intercepted by Northern Illinois. Johnny Fauston. It was tipped up in the air by Julian Jones, who couldn't catch the pass, and Fauston picks it off.
That's a play you have to make as a wide receiver. Just hit Julian Jones. You see him running against bump coverage against Fauston. Ball hits him right in the hands in the face mask. And Johnny Fauston, a great play. And to see the frustration on Ryan Applin's face, he knew he delivered the pass right where he wanted it to.
14th interception thrown by Applin, not his fault. And now great field position for the Huskies. On first down, double play fake. Harnish trying to throw deep. Man, wide open, broken coverage, touchdown. Arkansas State bit on the double fake and Moore scores. 43-yard hookup. Harnish to Martell Moore.
Northern Illinois with a lot of deception there. Watch the early handoff and then the end around. But look who's got the ball the entire time. Chandler Harnish, great work with the football, keeping it in his belly, disguising where it was. That is great ball handling in the backfield.
Northern Illinois. What a night for Martell Moore. 165 yards receiving now.
Hello, we're delighted to welcome you to Mobile, a dynamic global city that holds a magical mixture of world-class entertainment, stellar museums, fine dining, and historic attractions. Join us for a journey through Mobile. We hope to see you soon in Mobile, Alabama.
Boardwalk Empire Season 1, available January 10th on Blu-ray, DVD, and digital download.
You said you'd get me on the field.
I did get you on the field.
You are Brian Arakpo, all-pro linebacker. Surely you could do better than this.
Come on, sunshine. It's game time. Squad's waiting.
This is embarrassing, Brian. They've got me on the bottom of the pyramid.
You know what else is embarrassing? Paying too much for car insurance. Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
The old standby. The bare minimum. The game changer. Take it to the house with Taco Bell's Taco 12-pack. 12 classic crunchy tacos boxed up and ready for game day. Now at Taco Bell.
Division I student athletes have higher SAT and ACT scores than college-bound students.
The number of us receiving diplomas
is at an all-time high.
African-American males who are student athletes
are 10% more likely to graduate.
Still think we're just a bunch of dumb jocks?
You need to do your homework.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Northern Illinois as they get a nice strike. Harnish to Moore. As you see, Matt Canada, the first-year offensive coordinator for Northern Illinois, his second stint at NIU. He was on Joe Novak's staff for 6 years before spending the last seven at Indiana. And he said to us on the phone, you know, introducing the no huddle this year, I wanted to come in and inheriting Chandler Harnish, the biggest thing I wanted to do was not screw it up. He knew that he had a lot in place. And it took a little while for those guys to get in sync, but Harnish and Canada certainly have.
Yeah, and he said the team really responded to him in spring with the spring practice. Even though they were practicing outdoor in 30-degree weather, they were excited about this no-huddle offense, up-tempo. The guys have really grasped it quickly, and it's shown throughout the year.
Roll kick. Tryon. Comes to the near sideline. It's set across the 25 and down at the 27. In case you haven't heard, a big game tomorrow night at the Superdome. Number one LSU, number two Alabama. Coverage starts at 8 o'clock Eastern time. The All-State BCS National Championship on ESPN. It'll be six in a row for the SEC. All right, Danny, I'll put you on the spot here. Is that good for college football that one conference has dominated the game so much in recent years?
I don't think it's good. I mean, I don't think most people are happy there are two SEC teams in the title game either. But until somebody knocks them off, it's not going to change.
A run for Derek Lawson. And he'll get three on that play. Second down and seven for Arkansas State. Now down 28-13.
I still wish Oklahoma State would have gotten a shot at that national title.
You and a lot of other people.
Yeah.
What a game that's going to be tomorrow night. Just a couple of hours away from us here in Mobile, Alabama. Looks like they're still having issues with the game clock.
Which they had early at the end of the,
yes,
the first half. It was a little peculiar that there wasn't any time showing on the clock.
That's Sir Tom McCreesh, our lead official here tonight. ACC crew working this game.
Then we've had our audio issues with the refs tonight, too. I guess nobody had time to go to Radio Shack at halftime, right, to get a new mic.
There's an issue in-house with the game clock, and they're trying to get it worked out. So in-house audio problems here. We've got some gremlins at this game tonight.
It's clearly looking for something. Some way to communicate with the clock operator. If I'm a lip reader, I think he said put 13:21 back on the clock.
And now a timeout called for on the field. We're going to step aside as well. Hopefully all these issues will be cleared up by the time we come back.
Why should you get a domain name from GoDaddy.com? Because a domain name lets you do so many things on the internet. Use yours to build a website, to promote services or sell products, post your resume, register your baby's name, create a wedding site, then post photos and videos to share with family. Visit GoDaddy.com now to see more things domain names can be used for and get your very own GoDaddy.com. Domains, websites, and everything in between.
It's your social network all mixed together. With Galaxy Nexus by Samsung, now you can organize your contacts into circles like you do in real life. So you can choose what people see and what they don't. And with the speed of Verizon 4G LTE, you can chat as a group in a Google Plus Hangout without missing a beat. Introducing the first phone built for Android 4.0, only at Verizon.
Miller Lite won gold at the 2010 Great American Beer Festival for Best American Style Light Lager. What's winning taste like? Why don't you taste for yourself?
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
We need to know the scale of the epidemic.
1 billion sick. That's where we're heading.
When will we know what this is?
It's figuring us out faster than we're figuring it out.
Your wife is dead.
What happened to her?
They're setting up roadblocks.
People will panic.
Get away! Get away!
Contagion. Movie start at channel 125.
Miller Lite won gold at the 2010 Great American Beer Festival for Best American Style Light Lager. How'd Miller Lite win? Why don't you taste for yourself?
There's David Gunn, the interim coach at Arkansas State. Gus Malzahn ready to take this program over. Moments ago, we asked him about his top priority at Arkansas State.
Our top priority is taking this thing to the next level. You know, we want to get this program on a top 25 level year in and year out. I mean, they had a great season this year. They have a great chance of finishing the top 25. But our goal is to keep it there and be a consistent player in the top 25.
All right, Danny, how realistic is that at Arkansas State?
I think the foundation has been set. When you're talking about a guy like Gus Malzahn, with the resume that he has, what he accomplished at Auburn, getting that national title last year, and him stepping into this program, and even the speculation that Michael Dyer might join him there. Yeah. We're talking about a team to be contended with next year.
Well, Gus Malzahn, a top assistant at Auburn. We take a look at his resume. You know, before he got into the college ranks, he was a very successful high school coach in Arkansas, won a state championship, then was the offensive coordinator with the Razorbacks for 1 year under Houston Nutt before having two very explosive offensive seasons at Tulsa and then 3 years at Auburn, of course, coached a Heisman Trophy winner and won a national championship there.
Yeah, I think you've got to tribute Hugh Freeze for what he accomplished at Arkansas State this year and laying that foundation. And then with Gus coming in and what he can accomplish with the offensive weapons that he's got, with Ryan Applin coming back and, you know, some of these young receivers. We saw Taylor Stockamer with the big plays earlier. They've got a slew of guys at the wide receiver position. And Gus Malzahn with his offensive genius stepping in there. I think the future is bright for Arkansas State.
Well, they've got 13:21 put back on the clock now. It appears that the game clock issue has been fixed. Not sure if the microphone issue has been ironed out. David Gunn is getting the explanation from Tom McCreish. It's going to be second down and 7. Let's go down to Kara for an update.
The official that I just spoke with told me that the game clock discrepancy could not be fixed because of the microphone issue. Oh. So they had to dial up upstairs the old-fashioned way.
Hand in hand. Thank you, Kara. This is Ryan Applin looking for running room on the right edge. Can't find it. Boy, Kyle Jenkins stepping up for a big pop, a loss of 1. Thought he's played well tonight.
Yeah, he really has. Remember Clay in the first quarter? We were talking about Arkansas State's defense, you know, all these big hits and owning the game and dominating Northern Illinois. Well, now it's absolutely switched hands. Northern Illinois' defense is just controlling Arkansas State all across the board. They're getting pressure. They're getting tackles for loss. Arkansas State has not been able to do anything. 28 unanswered points.
Third down, 8. Applin feeling the heat, and down he goes. Allen Baxter with the sack.
Defensive coordinator Jay Neiman told us this would be a huge opportunity for Allen Baxter on the defensive line. But here's a look. Watch what Ryan Applin is looking at down the field. Not anywhere to go with the football. There is a Northern Illinois defender stride for stride with every Arkansas State receiver. That's just great coverage in the secondary.
Second sack of the Northern Illinois defense. Sullivan's punt is short, and it takes a Northern Illinois hop after checking up. Gus Malzahn is going to have a lot to work with starting next season, beginning with the quarterback, Ryan Applin. I mean, he's just a junior, so he's coming back. And you made mention of Dyer potentially heading to Jonesboro. David Gunn, the interim head coach for now, is staying on the staff. There are a lot of pieces already in place for Gus Malzahn to hit the ground running.
And to make that transition seamless. You know, we talked to David Gunn earlier in the week about his role with the team, and I think having him there, a guy who's been there for so long, for 10 years, I think that'll really help.
Harnish fires it out into the flat. Now that doesn't work out for Perez Ashford as he's dumped by Don Jones. Loss of 2.
And well, there's a look at Michael Dyer, which could be a huge get for Gus Malzahn. Sort of a package deal of sorts if he does end up at Arkansas State. And pretty much all indications are that is where he will end up. Should make for an exciting year for Arkansas State.
MVP of the national title game just a year ago. Harnish on second down and 13 incomplete. Moore, the intended receiver. And now, tempers flaring down on the field. There's Don Jones, number five, and Martell Moore having words.
It's good to see somebody on Arkansas State showing some fight. You see Martell Moore at the end gets hit by number five. Don Jones doesn't like it. Somebody needs to help spark this Arkansas State team to turn this game around.
On third down, Harnish. Incomplete. Jones in on the coverage. And Palmer wants a penalty flag. None thrown. Fourth down.
Don Jones is leading the charge right now for Arkansas State to try to get his team back in this game. First time it was the hit. This time he's in the slot in coverage on number 81. Nathan Palmer, stride for stride. Good coverage.
See, a lot of people would look at that and say there should have been a flag. You say good coverage.
He was running straight. I didn't see much contact there, did you? That's from a quarterback, too.
Yeah, that's why I was surprised.
I'm unbiased.
So try on the punt here on fourth down. Gets it away. Good kick. Fair catch being called for. And it'll be Arkansas State getting the football back down here by a couple of touchdowns. Tomorrow night, it's the rematch between LSU and Alabama. You cannot get a ticket for that game. It is absolutely impossible, and well, I shouldn't say impossible.
You can get a ticket.
It's going to cost you.
Open up your wallet.
It is going to cost you. 14 wins in a row for LSU. Arkansas State, Northern Illinois, 2-3 in longest winning streaks currently. Under 11 minutes to go, third quarter, deep down the sideline. That was intended for Jarbo. Melvin running stride for stride, second down.
You know, even though they didn't hit this route, the deep chance to Josh Jarbo, at least Arkansas State is making Northern Illinois respect him. You see here, here's the nine route, the outside. Rashad Melvin in good coverage once again. These DBs on both sides are playing really well, making it tough on these quarterbacks. But now Arkansas State can at least back off this Northern Illinois secondary.
Applin gives to Derek Lawson. Short gain, Pat Schiller, who has started every game at middle linebacker this season. That was Devon Butler's position to start spring practice, but Butler was involved in a drive-by shooting in DeKalb in April, and he is going to be okay. He's going to make a full recovery, maybe even going to be able to play again, but hasn't played this year. Applin in trouble. Looked like the ball might have popped out, and Northern Illinois has it. Stephen O'Neill knocked it loose, and Jason Meehan with the recovery.
Well, what a big hit. Top of your screen up there. Watch the defensive end come. Applin has no idea. This is a quarterback's worst nightmare from the blind side. Does not feel that pressure at all. And you just have no chance as a quarterback. You're trying to keep your eyes down the field. You try to secure the ball, but when you get hit in that blind side like that, the way O'Neill delivered that hit, really had no chance if you're Ryan Applin.
Boy, this defensive front for Northern Illinois, despite being shorthanded, has been great tonight. First down and goal now for the Huskies. Harnish. Perez Ashford wants to throw to the end zone. Did he catch it? No, incomplete. Intended for Ekus.
Oh, they tried a little trickeration. Tried a little reverse pass. Ashford way in the backfield. If he doesn't get that pressure on him, I think he's got a wide open pass he can complete. But a pretty good job by Arkansas State. Staying at home, putting pressure on Ashford while he's trying to throw it. Well, Matt Canada, the offensive coordinator, smiled before the game, said he had a lot of trick plays to call tonight.
Come on, come on, come on. Second down and goal. Harnish. Out into the flat, Akeem Daniels. Stopped at the five. Don Jones making another tackle for Arkansas State. Third Arkansas State turnover, and the Huskies trying to make them pay.
Northern Illinois shuttling an entire new unit of wide receivers on this play. They have so much depth at wide receiver, it's unbelievable.
Harnish, good pocket to pass, complete, but Hopkins hit as he made the catch. Tried to turn and run upfield, and Chaz Scales completely cut him down.
Chaz Scales, once again, we call his name. What a night. Great open field tackle. Recognize the pattern. Great anticipation, great read, and a great break on the ball.
So Northern Illinois will have to settle for a field goal attempt. 22-yard attempt for Matthew Sims. Hit the upright. No good. The second miss tonight for Sims. Missed from 33 in the first half, and now off the upright from 22.
Now if you're Arkansas State, you're looking for anything to change the momentum in this game. See the kick headed right at the upright, just doink.
Sims has been a hero a couple of times this year. In fact, in the MAC title game, that 33-yarder to beat Ohio. First team all conference, but tonight, a couple of misses.
And every time he's been sort of to the left. He's battled the hooks, sort of like a golfer. He's just been on that left side. Even on extra points tonight, he's missed him on the left side.
Let's see if those come back to haunt the Huskies. Penalty flag down on first down. Jarbo the catch. Close to a first down before he's ridden out of bounds by Durant, but there is a marker down. And Jarbo slow to get up for the second time tonight. Illegal motion on Arkansas State was the call.
Arkansas State just cannot get anything going. They just need one or two good plays to kind of get that momentum back in their favor. They just cannot get it done.
They've turned it over twice here in the second half. So a replay first down, but now first and 15. Applin again to Jarbo, this time too hot to handle. Second down at 15. Boy, the last six drives for the Red Wolves, four punts and two turnovers.
Yeah, and with their best receiver, Dwayne Frampton, out of this game with injury, somebody else is going to have to step up. Ryan Applin can't do it all. One of these receivers has to make a big play for him.
Applin fakes the throw and will run. Alan Baxter brings him down to the turf. It's a gain of seven for Arkansas State.
I'd love to see Arkansas State get Taylor Stockham, or number two, back in this game. Get the ball in his hands. He's a deep play threat. He's a playmaker.
Applin, complete. Caught by the tight end, Anthony Kinsey. The junior out of St. Pete, Florida, not used a lot in the passing game, gets the first down here.
Ryan Applin, watch the nice little step up here. Pass rush comes high, steps up in the pocket, gets rid of the ball. Pretty good pocket presence right there.
Quick strike. Earl Lucas tries to jump a tackler out of bounds. Jimmy Ward takes him out, but it's another first down for Arkansas State. Give him 13 on the play.
Oh, they've got a little bit of that momentum. You see a little more pep in their step. A couple nice plays in a row.
Northern Illinois with a timeout The first of the half, 7:33 to go in the third. Northern Illinois leads.
Everyone, meet our new GoDaddy girl, America's toughest trainer, Jillian Michaels. I am so pumped to be on the team.
Yeah, us too. We were just registering your domain name.
I just love how fast and easy it is to get a domain and a website at GoDaddy.com.
Oh, totally. Yeah.
Okay, well, let's continue with the rest of our tour. I'm gonna go back in. See what happens next at GoDaddy.com.
You said you'd get me on the field.
I did get you on the field.
You are Brian Arakpo, all-pro linebacker. Surely you could do better than this.
Come on, sunshine. It's game time. Squad's waiting.
This is embarrassing, Brian. They've got me on the bottom of the pyramid.
You know what else is embarrassing? Paying too much for car insurance. GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
What's going on?
We're giving Matt the NFL experience of a high-pressure field goal.
Oh! Oh! Look out! It's terrible, man!
There's an easier way to get an ultimate NFL fan experience. Just snap the tag wherever Bud Light is sold and you can win. Bud Light and the NFL. Here we go.
Hey, it gets easier. Really? No.
Would you like her to rephrase the question?
I'm not going to be the person I'm expected to be anymore.
Bien expected. Bleu de Chanel.
At Chanel.com.
The All-State BCS National Championship Game, Monday on ESPN.
ESPN College Football, the GoDaddy.com Bowl, is brought to you by Taco Bell, think outside the bun, and Verizon, your 4G LTE smartphone destination.
Had some pep rally last night here in Mobile, and tonight, Arkansas State jumped out to a 13-0 lead in the first 10 minutes of this game, but Northern Illinois has come back strong. They lead it 28-13 midway through the third quarter. With Danny Cannell and Kara Capuano on play Mapford. Beautiful night here in Mobile. Arkansas State has it at the 49 of Northern Illinois. Lawson stopped in his tracks. Delagol on the tackle.
Northern Illinois has done a tremendous job shutting down Arkansas State's rush game. That time you see number 29, Delagol, just coming off the edge. Not many rushing lanes for these running backs to get through.
He tried to set up the screen to Rod Hall. Northern Illinois was ready for that too. Deshaun Durant, the redshirt freshman, who became the starter at strong safety after the Central Michigan loss, makes the play there. Brings up third down and 8 for Arkansas State. They got a tough night on third down. Applin overshot Stockerman. There was the guy that you said they should look for. They did, but he was a little too long.
You see the frustration on Ryan Applin's face. Knew he had a great opportunity there. Northern Illinois brought a blitz. He had man-to-man down the field with Taylor Stockerman and just barely overthrew him. You only get those opportunities so many times in a game. You've got to capitalize when you get them. And Applin knows it. He knows he had a touchdown there.
We said before, he is complete on 66% of his passes coming into the night. He doesn't miss those very often. Davis, the fair catch at the 15. Let's take a look at tonight's H&R Block never settle play. And Jordan Lynch did a great job filling in for Harnish when he was out.
Yeah, with Harnish out, Jordan Lynch comes in. Watch the second effort, not settling for anything less than a touchdown. Jordan Lynch was fired up. Hadn't played much yet in his career. He's got to be pumped up about what the future holds as well.
It's not often the backup quarterback is your fourth leading rusher. I mean, he does play quite a bit, and the team never missed a beat when he was in there. Two series, and they produced. Now Jamal Womble. First down carry.
On the run, number five, Jamal Womble.
Don Jones makes the tackle, but it's a gain of 13 for Northern Illinois.
Pretty impressive run there by Womble on that one. Just running to the right side, makes a nice little cut up the field, evading one tackler, and then powers his way for a nice gain.
Northern Illinois up over 300 yards of total offense. Womble again. He is a stocky guy. 247 pounds, well under 6 feet tall.
Jamal Womble. Look at this little leap right there. You don't see that. And then the spread as well. Hey, whatever it takes to avoid those tacklers.
On second and three, this time Womble hitting the backfield.
The ball carrier number five, Jamal Womble.
And for Sean Lee, number 48, the redshirt freshman makes the tackle.
For Sean Lee, the middle linebacker, said he's seen enough of that jumping around in the backfield. Wrapped up Womble right away.
So now third and four. Look at Northern Illinois. Both of these teams have struggled on third down tonight.
Just giving him a free first down, jumping off sides. It's a veteran move by Chandler Harness, drawing him off with his cadence.
Prior to the snap, full start, left side of line, 5 yard penalty, remains third down.
Or the offensive line made a boneheaded play.
From the 20 down.
Here's a look, left side of your line.
Trevor Olsen, 54 career starts with the penalty, third and nine now. Harness hit hard and driven down on the blitz by DeMario Davis. First team all Sun Belt levels Harness for a loss of nine.
Oh, what a big play for the Wolf linebacker, DeMario Davis. Listen to the hit. Man, he came out of nowhere, was kind of hiding behind his defensive line and shot through there like a torpedo.
He leads the team in tackles. He has been invaluable for Arkansas State from a leadership standpoint during all the coaching upheaval. And now near to punt, gets it off. Tryon steps up, he is hit. There's a flag, as you would expect. He had no chance as Victor Jocks came in and hit him.
I remember Jocks from earlier in the first half. He got a penalty called against him for not giving the returner enough room. Time at sea, there were two players. Not only Jocks, but also number four, Deron Brown.
Personal foul, kick catch interference by the kicking team. 15 yards to the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
That's got to be very frustrating for Northern Illinois, because at this point in the game, you don't want to do anything to help Arkansas State get back into this game. And right there, you're giving them a huge edge with this field position. You're going to have a short field to work with.
They're going to spot the ball at the 42.
Now the big question is, can Arkansas State capitalize off of this field position? They have not been able to do anything their last five or six drives.
Applin backpedaling, throws, man, incomplete. Off the fingertips of Kinsey. The junior tight end couldn't haul it in.
And that's another play just off the fingertips of the tight end. Ryan Applin is going to, I know from personal experience, you miss these types of touchdown plays, it's going to be a tough sleep for a few nights. Just keep thinking about those missed opportunities.
The Huskies bring four. Applin got rid of it. And again, incomplete. That time, Rod Hall, the intended receiver. It's third down. As Arkansas State, great field position. They don't want to blow it here. Down 15 points.
No, that one, you know, it's an opportunity where you're trying to move the ball downfield. You get pressure. They just can't get anything on the same page.
Cranks, incomplete. In and out of the hands of Hall. Well covered in the secondary by Jimmy Ward.
Once again, I don't think you can realize how much of a playmaker Dwayne Frampton was for this Arkansas State offense, especially in third down situations like that when he just saw Applin just a little bit off on his throw to Rod Hall there. As a quarterback, you get comfortable. You find your favorite receivers, and when they're not out there, it can be very frustrating.
Yeah, when you get a guy like Frampton who has over 90 catches, there's a chemistry that develops, certainly. Sullivan to punt. And is going to take a Northern Illinois bounce. Close to the 30-yard line. Let's get a Sports Center right now with Ryan Burr.
All right, guys, what a game it was for Tim Tebow today against the Steelers in the playoffs. Went to overtime. First play of overtime. Demaryius Thomas, 80 yards. He is gone. One play, and the Broncos moving on. They'll play the Patriots on Saturday. Sports Center follows our game, guys.
All right, Ryan, thank you very much. 3:36. Left to go here in the third quarter. There is Frampton out with an injury on the Arkansas State sideline. The top receiver for the Red Wolves, and this offense has been different without him. Oh, a big hit. Akeem Daniels spun down hard by Scales, who has been an animal tonight.
Have another listen to this big hit. Time in the hot tub tomorrow, get some of these bruises out.
Justin Robertson, number 47, combined with Scales on that tackle, second and 12. Play fake, Harnish looking deep. Moore, hold it in, juggled it, and caught it. What a catch by Moore. Feimster and Jones had him well covered, but Moore made the grab a 39-yard play.
What a circus catch by Martell Moore. One-handed tips it to himself. Great focus, concentration to reel it in.
He pushed off a little bit, but the officials did not throw a flag. Harnish on first down. And we hit short of the line of scrimmage. Joyner makes another play for Arkansas State.
I mean, that pass was well defended. I was thinking, where's Chandler Harnish throwing this ball? It's pretty well covered. He knows he's got a receiver out there that's going to make a play for him in Martell Moore.
200 receiving yards tonight, 204 to be exact. Second and 12, Harnish looks left, comes back right to Ashford. And he'll get three. Jones out there to make the tackle immediately. So third down. Under 2 minutes to go in the quarter.
This game is pretty surprising the way it's unfolded. I mean, of course, Arkansas State with 28 unanswered points, but really Northern Illinois, they're doing everything through the air with their passing attack when they've been able to run the ball so well, too.
Yeah, they've had just 24 rushing yards tonight. This is from an offense that averages 248 on the ground.
You know, it's funny, Matt Canada, the offensive coordinator, said, hey, we take what they give us. Clearly tonight, it feels like they're giving them the passing game.
Play clock down to five. Harnish. Deep ball. Incomplete. Nathan Palmer didn't see it. I don't know that he was going to be able to get under it anyway. Try on good coverage. The redshirt freshman corner.
Nathan Palmer, earlier we saw him on a corner route. Same route this time. Looks like he lost the football again, trying to find it. A little contact there at the end. Chandler Harness trying to get on the same page. He's had a pretty spectacular night. Don't want to get too greedy out there.
So Northern Illinois gets to the 33-yard line of Arkansas State. The drive stalls out, and Ryan Neer comes on to punt. They can really pin Arkansas State deep. The 6-yard line is where Applin will go back to work, a 27-yard punt. Here's the quarterback comparison tonight. Keep in mind, Harnish missed a couple of series with an ankle.
Yeah, Harnish has been spectacular throughout the night. You just said Clay went off the field, but through the air tonight, just had a great night. Ryan Applin has had his chances. Of course, early in the game, came out, led a couple scoring drives, but just hasn't been able to get it going since the first quarter.
I think you touched on it. Without Frampton, he's missing something.
Yeah, he really is. And they said, when we talked to their play caller, Tyler Siski, he said Dwayne Frampton kind of is the key to everything. He sets up the deep routes because all the stuff he does underneath.
Incomplete. Frankie Jackson in the flat, and it was out of his reach.
You always wonder about teams that love to pass the football, how they're going to do after a month off without live game action. You know, Northern Illinois hasn't let it affect them, but clearly Arkansas State is just out of sync offensively.
Just 32 yards here in the third quarter for the Red Wolves. Second and 10. That is caught by Jarbo. And maybe a little spark here for Arkansas State.
Well, that was a really tight window that Ryan Applin just ripped that football through. Josh Jarbo with a nice catch. Like we talked about earlier, they just need a couple plays to get that momentum going.
Gain of 13, first and 10 as they get it out to the 23-yard line. Applin hands it off to Derek Lawson, the senior running back. Kyle Jenkins brings him down to the ground. We're at 40 seconds to go here in the quarter.
Arkansas State, I would love the first quarter, they came out with a tempo that was fast. They were ripping out there. Now everybody's just kind of standing around a little bit. They're not going as aggressive at the line of scrimmage. I'd love to see them put that pedal to the metal again. Go at Northern Illinois.
Applin juggled by Jackson. That throw again a little off target as Applin hasn't been nearly as sharp here in the second half. 15 seconds to go in the quarter.
Just been out of sync. He's been banged up a lot too. He's taken his lumps. Missed a couple opportunities down the field. A couple guys have dropped some balls, but I think you said it, Clay. The injury to Frampton has really hurt this offense.
Applin, was that picked off? Rashawn Melvin, did he get it? Yes, he did. He got his hands up underneath that football to pick it off. His third interception of the year and the fourth Arkansas State turnover tonight.
Arkansas State trying to take the pressure off Applin, giving him a nice, easy screen pass. He's forced to throw it early, out throws the back. Rashawn Melvin there with the diving catch. What's the recognition? He sees that screen coming early, is in the right place at the right time. Well, this Northern Illinois defense has made the most defensively. The ball's been in the air. They've made great catches on some of the turnovers.
They're going to review this, Danny. It really looked like he didn't get it.
The previous ruling on the field of an interception is being reviewed.
You know, let's see that again. It looked like that might have hit the ground.
He was definitely outstretched for that ball.
There's another angle that shows it better. I think that touched the ground. This is the angle. Right?
I don't know. There. I might have to disagree with you. I think he might have gotten those hands underneath it. I think that's a pretty good athletic catch. He looks like he has control of the ball, had a hand underneath there. I'll buy you a Coke, Clay, if they if they overturn it.
Big spender. Rosie Amato is the replay official. And Arkansas State really needs a break here.
They need something desperately to go their way, because if this ball is confirmed as an interception, the play stands. Another great field position opportunity for Northern Illinois. One more look at the catch by Melvin, or the attempted catch.
It's got to be indisputable video evidence, and might not be enough to overturn that.
I think there's enough to confirm that it was an interception. I think he got his hand underneath it, brought it up to his body, and then kind of rolled on top of it. But we shall see.
We've had some long stoppages tonight. Here's the call.
After review, the ruling on the field stands as called. Interception, first down.
So it wasn't confirmed, so there wasn't enough evidence to say that it for sure was a catch, but not enough video evidence to overturn it. Either way, you owe me a coach.
Four turnovers tonight for the Red Wolves. Just killers. Chandler Harnish with 10 seconds to work with here in the third quarter. Rolling. Caught by Moore. First down. Still on his feet. Down to the 12. That'll be the last play of the quarter. Northern Illinois after the turnover in the red zone again. They've got a 15-point lead headed to the fourth quarter. Interception. Confirmed.
Oh, you didn't get a Miller Lite?
No, what's the difference?
Miller Lite has more taste.
I don't care, I just got one of these.
Well, that's the second unmanly thing you've done today.
What was the first?
Hey, guys! I'm on a scooter!
Unmanly.
Man up and choose Miller Lite. We add hops not once, not twice, but three times. Brewed for that great Pilsner taste.
Hey, Ricky!
We ride together. What's up?
Ah, girl!
Randy?
Surprise.
You look amazing.
You just stay away from that boy.
Don't deny him, because he's my grandson.
On January 13th.
He's been trouble since he was 5 years old.
A new arrival.
I'd call you stubborn, but that'd be an insult to mules.
Brings out old rivalries.
You're breaking my hair!
Queen Latifah, Dolly Parton, Joyful Noise.
Whoa! Not to my table, that's where I eat.
Rated PG-13, starts January 13th.
New spaces to work, relax, and unfold at a value that's simply refreshing. And now the official hotel sponsor of the NFL. Courtyard, it's a new stay.
If you have gout and think a few attacks a year are all you have to worry about, think again. Fact is, gout can attack silently even between flares. You may not feel it, but gout's root cause, high uric acid, can allow crystals to continuously form and build up in your joints. Over time, this may lead to attacks in other joints, constant pain, and joint destruction. So don't wait. Get more information at goutinfo.com and talk with your doctor about ways to keep your uric acid at a lower, healthy level.
Leadership, excellence, performance. It's what Heisman and Aflac's all about. Aflac, an official partner of the Heisman Trophy.
See war like never before. Get the Emmy Award-winning miniseries World War II in HD, along with two feature-length specials in the World War II in HD collector set, available with Vietnam in HD at Barnes & Noble Music and DVD locations and at VN.com.
What if an entire car insurance company was thought up and built and run to save you money? What if that company was Esurance and this wasn't a hypothetical question? Could be coolish. Esurance. Click or call.
It looks like he wants some gas. How's it going, gentlemen?
What's up, man?
Gas prices keep going up.
Crazy, man.
And seeing how I saved hundreds on car insurance with Progressive, this takes on me.
And we getting a whole free tank of gas. The dude from the Progressive commercial, man, he just filled up our tank for us.
Appreciate it.
Take care. Free tank of gas.
Man, switch to Progressive, dog. They doing a lot of good out here, man.
Tell them the messenger sent you.
Tonight's game summary brought to you by Marriott Courtyard. Go to the fourth quarter, 28-13, Northern Illinois. Arkansas State jumped out to a 13-0 lead. There has not been much of a run game for either team. But now keep in mind, Arkansas State, a very good fourth quarter team. They're down here by two scores. 15-point deficit, but look at that. In the fourth quarter, they're outscoring opponents 111-31.
Really, their offense is built to score quickly. They play at a fast tempo. They're perfectly capable of putting points on the board. They just have to find a way to generate some production, some points.
Applin started out strong. He has cooled off considerably in the second half, but keep in mind, Dwayne Frampton, his leading receiver, is out of this game on the sideline with an injury. Stockamer has been very good. It's just Northern Illinois has done a great job adjusting and cooling him off, too, here since halftime. And four turnovers tonight for Arkansas State have really hurt the Red Wolves. Three in the last six drives, and now back in the red zone, the Huskies. First down and 10 from the 12. They'll run it to start the quarter. Womble straight ahead. Three hard-earned yards as Joyner brings him down. I think Womble is probably the hardest runner that Northern Illinois has.
He's a load, 5'11", 247 pounds. He is a tough guy to bring down.
And pick up a first down at the two. Second down. Harnish lobs it to the end zone, looking for more in the corner. Incomplete. Scales is covering him in the corner.
We've called number 25, Chaz Scales. We've called his name a lot tonight. Here he is, locked up in coverage. Pretty good form. Getting a little hand action on him, feeling that receiver. Martell Moore saying, where are you at? Ball just overthrown a little bit too, but Chaz Scales done a pretty good job tonight on the outside.
Third down, Harnish to Moore. Took three to bring him down, but it's a big tackle. They stop him a couple of yards short of the first down. So it's fourth down for Northern Illinois.
That's a big stop for Arkansas State, too. I mean, they're already down by such a deficit, they can't afford to give up another touchdown. Remember what happened last time. The last field goal attempt hit the uprights from Matthew Sims.
He's actually missed his last two field goal attempts. He's missed from 33 and 22. This again from 22.
These are really chip shots, too.
A big sigh of relief for Matthew Sims as the lead goes to 18. Well, tomorrow, ESPNU gets you prepared for the All-State BCS National Championship. At 3 Eastern, Palmer and Pollock give their take on what to expect in New Orleans. At 4, a two-hour edition of BCS Countdown as the experts break down the All-State BCS National Championship. And finally at 6 Eastern at Sports Nation. We've got it for you on ESPNU. Nick Saban against the hat, Les Miles. All right, when it comes down to coaching, who do you give the edge to?
You know, I was just getting ready to comment on how different they are, but they're such great coaches, even though they have such different styles. Les Miles, obviously, pretty quirky. Nick Saban, more cerebral. You know, he's such a great disciplinary, just the little things. He's so attention to detail. I just think it's going to be a huge challenge for LSU to beat Alabama, not only the second time because they beat them early, but going back to last year, it'll be the third time in a row they'll have had to beat Alabama. And I just don't see that happening. As good as LSU is, I just think it's going to be too much to overcome.
I just think that it essentially being a home game for LSU is going to be hard for Alabama to overcome. I like the Tigers. So after the score by NIU, it's Rod Hall on the return. Good return, too. Across the 40-yard line, down to the 41, a 29-yard return for Hall. And that's the kind of effort Arkansas State needs here down the stretch.
They're definitely not laying down. They're not ready to go out without a fight. Rod Hall is leading the way at the end of that run. Running over number two, Sean Evans for Northern Illinois. And Arkansas State once again has great field position to start this drive.
From the 41, Applin to the outside, underthrown for Jarbo, but he got the catch.
The time Ryan Applin had to drop down his release a little bit. See it almost get batted down by some Northern Illinois defenders. That's the reason that ball might have been a little bit lower to Jarbo.
Second and 4. Applin again to the air. And to the tight end, Kinsey. Kinsey was hobbled on the last pass attempt that he was involved in. Makes the catch here, first down. 31 unanswered points for Northern Illinois. Arkansas State up against it now here in the fourth quarter. Applin. Jarbo. Penalty flag. Rashawn Melvin down there. Pass ruled incomplete, and there's a marker down.
Arkansas State and Ryan Applin trying to take a shot down the field, a little back shoulder throw attempt, a lot of contact.
Pass interference, number 11 defense, 15 yards in the previous line of scrimmage, automatic first down.
Melvin had the big play with the interception not that long ago, and this time flagged for the 6th Northern Illinois penalty. So now inside the 35, Arkansas State on the move. A lot of time left on the clock.
Plenty of time for this offense, too.
Applin sets up the screen, gets a block. Earl Lucas, first down. And out of bounds.
These bubble screens are really set up by the wide receivers that don't catch the ball. Watch the block right there. Seals the DB to the inside, so the bubble screen, the guy who caught it, is able to get to the outside.
Stockamer with the block, number 2. Applin, complete. Lucas fighting his way. Down to the 15-yard line. Jordan Delegal on the tackle, but an 8-yard gain, 12 minutes to go.
On Arkansas State's just hanging around. They're still in this game, very much so. Northern Illinois had to settle for some field goals recently, missed one. You said it, Clay. Hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
Now this time, Lawson hit by Jefferson. I really like the way Nabal Jefferson plays the game. He is a physical D-tackle.
Yeah, and those inside linemen, those interior defensive linemen, they don't get a lot of love because they don't get many opportunities to make big plays. But Nabal Jefferson called his name a few times tonight.
3rd and 4. Applin pumps. Now under pressure, throws it toward the back of the end zone on a play.
Well, Ryan Applin, you saw him pump fake to the left. I thought it was a fake, but it was a miscommunication. Watch, he wanted to throw that ball to the left, then had to throw it away, but watch him talk to the receivers. He's fired up, saying, we gotta look quick. We want to get rid of that ball.
Big fourth down for Arkansas State.
Oh, and this is where they wish they had Dwayne Frampton on the field. Somebody has to step up.
The Huskies bring four. Applin has time. Now the pocket closes to the end zone. Caught! Stockamer, the catch! And Arkansas State has life.
Well, somebody had to step up for Arkansas State, and Taylor Stockamer stepped up in a huge way. There was nowhere to go with that football for Ryan Applin. It was well covered all across the board. Watch Stockamer, just a jump ball, catches the ball at the highest point with one hand.
Stockamer, his first catch since the second quarter. He had a huge first half, and that is certainly his biggest catch of the game. .148 receiving yards for Stockamer. A beautiful catch, and Arkansas State has new life.
Taylor Stockamer with a big one-handed grab like a rebound. The deficit has been cut to 11.
Hello, we're delighted to welcome you to Mobile, a dynamic global city that holds a magical mixture of world-class entertainment, stellar museums, fine dining, and historic attractions. Join us for a journey through Mobile. We hope to see you soon in Mobile, Alabama.
Financial advice is everywhere.
Real, objective investing help?
That's a little harder to find.
But here's what I know. TD Ameritrade doesn't manage mutual funds.
Or underwrite stocks and bonds.
Or even publish their own research.
So guidance from TD Ameritrade isn't about their priorities. It's about money.
Straightforward guidance. That's what makes TD Ameritrade different.
Trade commission-free for 60 days. Plus, get up to $600 when you open an account.
Entune Mobile Technology. Stay seamlessly connected to your smartphone. Available on the reinvented 2012 Camry from Toyota.
When it comes to home insurance, surprises can be a little scary.
And a little costly. That's why the best agents present their clients with a lot of options.
Because when it comes to what's covered and what's not, nobody likes surprises.
We totally thought you were...
Obscure space junk falling from the sky? We covered that. Moving on.
We are insurance.
We are farmers. Bum, ba, bum, 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 bum.
It's SportsCenter after the game. Robert Flores, Steve Levy, Tim Tebow electrifies in the Mile High City. We'll have the latest and look ahead to their game next week.
And three Sunday conversations for the price of one. Les Miles, Nick Saban, and Jay Paterno coming up on SportsCenter.
In the absence of leading Arkansas State receiver Dwayne Frampton, Ryan Applin has found a go-to guy. It's Taylor Stockamer.
Oh, watch what happens here on this touchdown. He's got a slew of wide receivers that are tall. And I always love tall wide receivers because you can throw it up high. They can out-jump people and go up and get it for you. That's exactly what Taylor Stockamer did on that last touchdown.
Pretty quick scoring drive, too. Just a little over 2 minutes taken off the clock. Plenty of time left in this game for Arkansas State as Zalad kicks it low. ground ball fielded at the 7-yard line by Tommy Lee Lewis. Finds a seam up the middle, good return across the 30-yard line.
Let's have a look at the touchdown play. Here's Stockmer, top of your screen. He's just gonna run and basically post up in the end zone. Thing I like about Ryan Applin, he knows it's 4th and 4. So he doesn't want to take a sack. He says, hey, I'm just gonna throw it up and give my guy a chance. If you take a sack there, you don't gain anything. So an interception, it's no big deal. And if you get a touchdown, it's huge. It's a huge momentum shift.
First points since there was 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter for Arkansas State. Play clock to 5. Harnish keeps it. Good run on first down for Chandler Harnish. They pretty much abandoned the run up to this point. And now they'd like to take some time off the clock.
They definitely would. At this point in the game, here comes the big power read zone that they run so much. Harnish able to get a nice gain. And like you said, Clay, at this point, especially with Arkansas State scoring a touchdown, they would love to milk a lot of time off the clock.
First down.
Same backfield, see if it's the same play. Yep.
This time they give it to Akeem Daniels. Same result, first down Huskies.
That's what makes that play so tough. It's so tough to defend, especially with a guy like Chandler Harnish in the backfield. He makes good decisions with the football, knows when to give it to the back, knows when to keep it. Once again, same formation, see if they keep going it.
Just 41 rushing yards tonight for Northern Illinois. Well below their average. 200 yards below their average. Batted in the air and nearly picked off. Dorvis Woods, the defensive tackle, knocked it in the air and almost picked it off.
I guarantee you Chandler Harnish's heartbeat just raced. Because that is a scary feeling. Defensive end, top of your screen, kind of settles in. And Harnish very alertly goes over to bat that ball down.
Second team all Sun Belt. Dorvis Woods with the play at 2nd and 10. Harnish gets away from one tackle, lobs it up downfield, incomplete. Nathan Palmer, the intended receiver. Don Jones again in the vicinity on the coverage.
Chandler Harnish was under extreme duress on that pass. Pretty amazing that he found a way to get this ball out. There he avoids Brandon Joyner. He takes a lick from DeMario Davis. That's two guys that are going to be playing in the NFL next year for Arkansas State. Harnish avoided both of them.
Now, Jordan Lynch comes on. Harnish is on the sideline here for a 3rd down and 10.
You got to wonder if they have a situational play here.
And Lynch keeps it on the ground. Interesting decision there. What was that all about, Danny? You have any idea?
Unless Chandler Harnish, we just talked about him getting hit on that last play. If he nicked that ankle that's been bothering him, you know, or they just they knew they were a quarterback sneak. So maybe they just figured, hey, why risk injury to Harnish? Let's just run, let the backup in there to run it.
So coming out to punt for the 7th time will be Ryan Neer. Play clock down to 5. Get it off. Neer. And a fair catch called for by Tryon. Arkansas State has a little momentum, down 11. A lot of time on the clock, over 9 minutes to go. Who's going to hoist the trophy tonight? Come back to find out.
Here's why you need a domain name from GoDaddy.com. Because a domain name lets customers, family, or friends find you on the internet. And with every GoDaddy.com domain name, you get a free instant page website. Use your site to sell products or promote services. Post your resume, create a wedding site, then post photos and videos. Visit GoDaddy.com now to see more things domain names can be used for and get your very own. GoDaddy.com. Domains, websites, and everything in between.
What do I want? I want horsepower. Cleaner horsepower. I want power that dominates the road. and fuel efficiency that respects the earth. Give me 43 miles per gallon and the rush of 200 horsepower. What I want is the best of both worlds.
Introducing the reinvented 2012 Camry Hybrid from Toyota.
Leadership, excellence, performance. It's what Heisman and Aflac's all about. Aflac, an official partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Let the value lead you to a dinner they love at a price you love. Hot and ready pizza, just $5 at Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza.
Laces? Really? Slip-on's the way to go. More people do that, security would be like a...
There's no charge for the bag.
Thanks. I know a quiet little place where we get some work done is a three-prong plug.
I have club passes.
Now there's a mileage card that offers special perks on United, like a free checked bag, United club passes, and priority boarding.
Thanks. Okay. What's your secret?
The new United Mileage Plus Explorer card. Get it, and you're in.
ESPN College Football, the GoDaddy.com Bowl, is brought to you by GoDaddy.com, domains, websites, and everything in between, and Toyota.
Back here in Mobile, 9:14 to go, Northern Illinois trying to hold off Arkansas State. Alongside Danny Cannell on play, Matt Caracapuano down on the field. Arkansas State gets it back. First down and 10 from the 14-yard line of the Red Wolves. Here's Applin to throw. Behind the receiver, Jarbo. Demetrius Stone, the junior from Miami, in on the coverage. Second down.
That ball was a little bit behind Josh Jarbo, but in this type of situation, you're trying to get your team back, you've got to make those plays.
Applin, 260 passing yards, a touchdown. He's been picked off twice. His first half better than his second half has been. Play fake to the outside. It's complete. This is Carlos McCants, a Mobile native who went to LaFleur High School here in town. Gets 9. Faustin on the tackle. And it's going to be third down and short.
Pretty good read there by Ryan Applin. Being patient. You don't have to get it all at once. Plenty of time on the clock. He took the underneath route for positive yardage to get them in this third and manageable situation.
Applin quickly to the outside. Stockamer, first down. Arkansas State has outscored its opponents with that touchdown now here in the quarter, 118-34. Second down, intended for Kinsey. It was well off target. So Arkansas State has it in their DNA for big comebacks. Certainly within striking distance, down 11, plenty of time on the clock, and they've got the football.
Yeah, and you watch them out there. They're not panicked. They're still going about their business, about their offense. They're playing with a little bit more sense of urgency than they did early, but I like it. I think they need to.
Applin intercepted. Deshaun Durant. Touchdown, Northern Illinois. Ooh, that's a backbreaker for the Red Wolves. The third INT thrown by Applin here tonight.
When Northern Illinois' defense has just continually stepped up this entire game, they've made so many big plays. So much of the attention has gone to Northern Illinois' offense throughout the year with all the Chandler Harness has accomplished. But their defense tonight has been stellar.
And the lead, once again, 18. Deshaun Durant. Pick six, 36 yards to the house. The redshirt freshman from Charlotte, North Carolina, with a huge play for the Huskies.
Super Tuesday, Georgia, Florida at 7, Ohio State, Illinois at 9 on ESPN.
Helping. Pass it on.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
What a nice young man. My goodness.
Five turnovers tonight for Arkansas State. This one really hurts, Danny.
Here's Deshaun Durant. He's in man coverage against Earl Lucas right in the slot. It's great coverage, but watch the critical mistake that Brian Applin makes. He throws it behind the receiver. When a receiver is running an out-breaking route, you cannot afford to miss to the inside. You've got to miss outside if you're Ryan Applin.
And Northern Illinois has made this team pay tonight. You see the points off turnovers. Not only are they turning it over, but they're getting hurt by these turnovers. And now it's a three-possession game. Tryon. After the 26, let's go to the studio and Ryan Burke.
All right, Clay, here's your SportsCenter right now. Last team to punch their ticket to the divisional round of the NFL playoffs, the Denver Broncos. They needed one play of overtime. Demaryius Thomas, 80 yards from Tim Tebow. It's the Broncos and the Patriots next Saturday. SportsCenter follows our game.
All right, Ryan, we'll see you in just over 8 minutes of game time here in Mobile. There is Ryan Applin, the Sun Belt Conference Player of the Year. He's had some magic in his arm throughout this season. See if he's got it again here tonight late in this game. He'll throw. And he'll hit Stockamer. Good run after the catch. He's been doing that all night. First down.
And now for Arkansas State, they really have to pick up the tempo. That sense of urgency has to escalate. It's a three possession game. They've got to get three scores, so they need to score quickly. That play clock is their worst enemy right now.
Stockamer hit as he tried to catch that. They're going to whistle that play dead, incomplete. Rashawn Melvin with a beautiful hit on that play. He has been outstanding tonight.
Several defensive players have had great big games tonight. Rashawn Melvin is one of them. Recognizes the quick pass, comes from the outside, puts his helmet right on the football to knock that ball loose. Probably a better thing for Arkansas State. That ball was incomplete because it stopped the game clock.
Second down and 10. Applin over the middle. That is caught by McCants. A couple of yards short of the first down. Melvin immediately brings him down after the catch. It's a gain of 8. Melvin with an interception tonight. And another loss. Lawson dropped.
And you try to sneak in a draw, catching the defense in more of a prevent style defense, but you've got to get past that defensive line first. And so they couldn't even do that.
Fourth and 7.
Oh, now they're just letting so much time run off the clock.
Yeah, they have not been efficient on this drive. They need the 49 of Northern Illinois. Here comes the pressure. Applin to the outside, behind the receiver. McCants was the intended guy. He was still looking upfield when that ball whizzed by him.
Yeah, Ryan Applin was trying to throw a back shoulder fade route, which means Carlos McCants should have expected that ball sooner, but McCants thought it was going to be thrown deep down the field. You saw him get his head around just too late. Ryan Applin's a little frustrated with some of the contact there at the end, and it's been a frustrating night for him.
And so Northern Illinois takes over on downs. And even though they have not run the ball a lot tonight, we expect to see a heavy dose of the run here on out for Northern Illinois.
You would definitely expect them to really go into four-minute mode, which means exclusively run game.
There is Hopkins, first down on the carry. Eludes some tackles along the sideline. Harold finally brings him down.
Should see Northern Illinois keep the ball mostly on the ground. Try to keep the ball in bounds. Avoid penalties, anything that stops the clock.
Hopkins, one of the 19 seniors. A win tonight makes this the winningest class in Northern Illinois history. This would be the 35th win for Chandler Harnish, Jasmine Hopkins, and the other 17 seniors. Taking as much time as they possibly can. Play clock under 10.
Should see them snap it about two or three every time.
Hopkins still on his feet, spinning. Joyner finally wrestles him down. Pass of three. Don't forget, coming up next, SportsCenter immediately after the conclusion of the GoDaddy.com Bowl here in Mobile, Alabama. Too many turnovers tonight for Arkansas State. Got out to a great start, but they started to pile up.
They really did. I mean, first quarter, they were up 13 to nothing. Really were wondering how Northern Illinois would respond, and the senior-laden offense really responded to the challenge they were faced with early in this game.
Harnish. It's knocked down. Nathan Harold bats that down. So it's going to bring up third down.
I'm not entirely shocked that they called a pass there, but I am shocked that Chandler Harnish chose to throw it where he did. I mean, in this situation, if you're trusting your quarterback, if you're going to take a shot, be extremely careful with the football, because the worst thing that could have happened there is you throw that interception, which that ball could have been picked off.
Harnish, 274 passing yards tonight. He doesn't run much because of the tender ankle. Fakes and now hit. Went down hard, too, at the 44-yard line. Nigel Byrd in on the play, so is Joyner, number 99. And so, fourth down now for Northern Illinois, and they will punt.
Fourth down.
They won't punt for about 25 seconds, though, Clay, because they are going to let this clock run down as much as they can. And who knows, maybe they might even take a delay of game to get every second possible.
Tryon back to return. Frampton, the top punt return guy, out with that injury. The one, Deron Brown. Pats on the back for Ryan near the punter. A 41-yard kick.
Hello, we're delighted to welcome you to Mobile.
15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Northern Illinois, 419 away from winning the GoDaddy.com Bowl here in Mobile. Super Tuesday begins this week on ESPN. Action begins in the SEC at 7 Eastern, Georgia and number 14 Florida. And then Ohio State, 7th-ranked team in the country, taking on the Illini at 9 Eastern. Long field for Arkansas State, down 18. They led 13 to nothing in the first half. Kaplan going deep. Incomplete. Stockamer, the intended receiver. Melvin in on the coverage. Northern Illinois for the second game in a row, Danny. Impressive comebacks in the MAC title game. Trailed 20 to nothing to Ohio in the first half. Rallied back to win the championship here tonight. Got down early, didn't panic, and they are close to a victory here tonight.
We talked to Dave Doran. He described his team. Said he liked to do things the hard way.
Well,
they don't make things easy on themselves, that's for sure, but they have a great work ethic, put in a lot of hard work and effort. They've got the hard way. It's kind of their team motto. It's up in their weight room up in DeKalb. Get it on the back of their helmets as well.
Third and one. Incomplete. Kyle Jenkins. Good play there. Got a piece of that for Northern Illinois. So fourth down for Arkansas State. And Applin's going to head off the field.
I think that's the white flag waving right there on a fourth and one at this point in the game and punting it away.
That's Ryan Wilburn. The rugby style punter for Arkansas State. And short kick with 3:41 to go. Chandler Harnish, his career wrapping up. Legendary quarterback at Northern Illinois, and a lot of people think that he'll get a sniff in the NFL. What
yeah,
do you think?
You know, from what I've seen of him, he's got the one intangible that everybody looks for. He's a winner. He's 22-5 now as a starter. He's got amazing tools with what he can work with as a runner. The thing that's, of course, going to hurt him is his size. But you know what could happen? The Denver Broncos are going to need a backup for Tim Tebow that is similar in style of play.
There you go.
I'm telling you, they're going to have to do that because they can't put a regular quarterback behind him back there.
For more on Chandler Harnish, let's go down to Kara Capuano.
It's not often when you have the head coach tell you that a young player is the best thing that ever happened to him. But for defensive-minded Dave Doran, having this fifth-year senior quarterback, Chandler Harnish, taking the snaps was a huge coup in his first year in his career as a head coach.
He will leave with over 4,500 yards of total offense for this season. Ninth in the country at 333 yards per game. Just an impressive senior year for Chandler Harnish. Not a pretty exchange there, but Hopkins gets it, picks up one. Feenster at the tackle. There you see the numbers for Harnish there. Total offense, Applin and Harnish pretty comparable coming into this game. But Harnish, despite being nicked up, despite having a slow start, wins the battle tonight.
And you know, the other thing, talking about NFL scouts, they love somebody who's tough, who can play through the pain, kind of whatever injury they're faced with, they can kind of gut it out. And that's what he did. I mean, he went into the locker room. And Clay, you and I looked at each other and said, man, it does not look good. He had his shoes off and was limping heavily on that ankle. Went into the locker room, got it taped up, maybe took a little Advil or something stronger. And it's good to see him back here and tough it out.
Came bursting out of the locker room like Willis Reed. With a win tonight, the MAC will get their fourth victory of the bowl season. Pretty good. Five bowl teams and four wins. Not bad for the conference. Third down and four. Incomplete. And a marker on the play.
Holding, 71 the offense, 10 yards from the previous line of scrimmage. It remains third down.
Scott Wettage, the center. Final game of his collegiate career, the Elkhorn, Wisconsin native. The 11 wins for Northern Illinois this season. Tonight will be the 11th. Ties a school record set last year. Don't forget SportsCenter coming up next. And it looks like Northern Illinois is going to attempt a field goal.
It's kind of that point in the game where it gets just a little awkward, especially Arkansas State, by not going for it on that fourth and one. You don't want to feel like you're running up the score, but you're in field goal range. Why not kick it?
Sims from 42 has missed a couple tonight. Doesn't look like it's going to matter. And this field goal attempt is also no good. It's been a tough night for Matthew Sims. But Northern Illinois is poised to win this game in spite of that. Turnovers have really hurt Arkansas State. That, when you boil it down, is the story of this game.
I mean, it's a killer for any offense to overcome. Saw there Julian Jones batted the ball up, picked off by Northern Illinois. That time from the blind side, Ryan Applin gets stripped. There's a look at Rashawn Melvin making a great catch. And finally, Deshaun Durant with a pick six late in this game to put it on ice for Northern Illinois.
Ryan Applin still out there working hard. The quarterback throws it down the field and continues to hook up with Stockamer, gets out of bounds.
These Arkansas State receivers, you know, once they lost Dwayne Frampton, that was obviously a huge loss, but guys they have coming back next year like Stockamer and Josh Jarboe, Julian Jones, Alan Muse, they've got a slew of guys coming back. A lot of those guys are big, too, 6'3 and above.
Trophy ceremony after the game on ESPN3. Applin, incomplete. McCants doing battle down there with Foster. This will be second down. Gus Malzahn announced as the new head coach for Arkansas State in December, a big coup for this university. And there is Gus Malzahn. Great ties in the state of Arkansas. You know that's going to help that university in recruiting. Applin completes it to McCants, and he paid the price. Bouston just laid him out short of the first down.
It's interesting, the ups and downs these Arkansas State players have had to go through the last 6 weeks or so. First they find out their head coach, Hugh Freeze, is leaving for Ole Miss. So they're down, they're depressed, and then all of a sudden they find out they're getting Gus Malzahn to come in there. Talk about running the gamut of emotions.
Applin, out of bounds. Malzahn is just 46 years old. Young, energetic.
Of course, with a national title under his belt at Auburn with Cam Newton.
Good things lie ahead for this program in Jonesboro, Arkansas, no question about it.
Oh, the best part about Gus Malzahn, he's a guy from the state of Arkansas who knows the state well. We talked to him before the game and said he knew that was going to be an important factor for the recruiting game and felt he knows Arkansas like nobody else.
McCants with the catch, keeps the drive alive. Clock stops as they move the chains, a minute and a half to go here. Arkansas State trying to end this game on a positive note. 14-yard pickup. We'll start the clock again. Applin. Incomplete. Hall. Couldn't hang on, and good reason why. Stone and Evans really had that covered well, and it made him pay the price.
See that the talent there that Ryan Applin has as a passer, zipping that ball down the field. See the future he has. Next year he's going to return as a senior, hoping to replicate all the success he had this year.
Now Applin from behind steps out of a tackle. Baxter in pursuit and gets it off complete to Lucas. And he steps out of bounds to stop the clock with a minute and 17 to go. Got the Gatorade ready to go on that Northern Illinois sideline. Third and one, first down, Lawson down to the 15.
That's something they would have liked to have seen earlier in this game. That rushing attack pretty much shut down by Northern Illinois.
First down. Lawson again, this time just a yard. As Baxter wraps him up. It's hard for a guy that size to be sneaky.
Oh, now you can hear him talking about it. Hit him good. Nail him. I love it.
Under 40 seconds to go. Incomplete. And a flag. McCants, the intended receiver. Perhaps Demetrius Stone with the penalty here. Here they come. At least it's a warm night in Mobile.
There is no foul. The ball was tipped behind the line of scrimmage.
They'll pick up the flag. There's Dave Doran.
You think any of these coaches, they have to know it's coming.
Yeah, the hair on your neck has to start to stand up. Kind of right before lightning hits you. A lot of time for Apple. And lobs it up out of play. Fourth down. Perhaps the last play of the year for Arkansas State. Coming up. What a breakthrough year for this program. You might get it twice. Fourth down, Applin throws, batted down, and that's going to do it as Northern Illinois will take over, and Dave Doran gets a bath here in Mobile.
No better way to end your season than getting that shower right there, and Dave Doran deserves it for the year he's had with Northern Illinois. Chandler Harnish put a pretty nice bow on his career that he's had. This Northern Illinois team has been resilient. Their defense, young. Their offense, full of a lot of veteran guys that they'll have to replace next year. Got a glimpse of Jordan Lynch, who's going to have to replace Chandler Harnish. But the future looks bright for Northern Illinois.
Chandler Harnish takes a knee. He'll finish his career 22-5 as the Huskies starter the last 2 years. And Northern Illinois got behind in this game 13-0, but they win it 38-20 here in Mobile. That's going to do it for the GoDaddy.com Bowl. Coming up next on ESPN at SportsCenter, this has been a presentation of ESPN, worldwide leader in sports. For our ESPN production team, Danny Cannell and Kara Capuano, I'm Clay Matvick saying good night for Mobile. Now we go to Ryan Burr in the studio at SportsCenter.
Well, Kim throws pass. Caught to Demaryius Thomas. Touchdown, Denver! It's over! It's over in Denver!
This is SportsCenter.
Yet another reason to trust in Tebow. A little dose of Mile High Magic sends the Steelers.